Welcome to Aristocrats, the weekly series in a world where adventure awaits any worthy adventurer, but not these guys. These guys are going to be doing adventures that nobody else would touch with a 10-foot poleaxe. Today we got playing with us Ronnie Adrian, Miles Stroth, and Heather Campbell. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hey. Hello.
Hi.
Yay.
Yay.
Yes, yes, we're all so excited.
Yes.
If you are watching on twitch.tv, if you want to vote on stuff as we go along and play, you can go to jash.com/play. You can vote on things like what they're going to, if they're going to get certain loot, who gets the loot at the end of the adventure, how you think they're doing, and stuff like that. And the adventure we're going to do next week. So I'm your DM, Clay Larson, also. Always forget that part. Mildly important. Hi, guys. Before we get started, why don't you guys go down the line and just tell us real fast what you do and what character you're playing and anything you want to tell us about that character. Heather, why don't you start?
Okay, great. Hi. Hi, I'm a comedian. Right, that's what you mean?
Sure.
Real life?
Sure.
Wait,
I realized I was not clear about that. Sure, I was going to say what you do. Plug yourself, I guess, if you want.
Oh, okay.
And then about your character.
Okay, great. Please watch me on Whose Line Is It Anyway on the CW Network, as our new season has just started. I am playing Cratch. Is this camera right? I'm playing Cratch, who is a tiefling barbarian, and this is my second time playing as Cratch. We learned that Cratch has a dead daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Also, last episode that Heather was on, she sold everything that she was wearing. And then later on, and also we should probably mention that you're a were-raccoon.
Oh, and I got bit by a raccoon, and now I'm a were-raccoon.
Yep.
Which affects some of my stats.
Yep. That is a curse that, if I remember correctly, Leland could have cured you of, and you said, no, I don't want to not be this. And also, all you're wearing is a kilt made of a were-raccoon skin of one of the ones you killed.
With a sword in it, an axe or something,
yes,
right?
Yes, an axe. Awesome. Miles?
Hi, I'm Miles Stroth. I run the Pack Theater in Hollywood. I'll be playing a tiefling warlock named Jimmy, because nobody fucks with Jimmy. That's all I got.
That's great.
Hi, I'm Ronnie Adrian. I'm also a comedian. I don't run a theater or on TV show, so... but I can tell you one thing. My character is Guaplar 3000, and he is a human sorcerer.
Ooh.
Yeah. Awesome, guys.
How big are tieflings? Are they smaller?
Tieflings are like human size. Similar range to humans.
But they're the ones with like dragon traits or spider traits?
Demon traits.
Demon traits.
Tieflings, generally somewhere in their ancestry, their ancestors either made a pact with a demon or fucked a demon.
Okay, great.
A drawing I saw is that they had a tail.
Yeah.
Kind of lizard-like.
Yeah, a little lizard-like. Think like infernal demon type of tail, kind of.
Like alien.
Yeah.
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 Alien.
Great. So, guys, you find yourselves in the city of Calmstone at about 9 a.m. in the waiting room in the offices of Tavlin's Temporium LLC, the fantasy temp agency that you're waiting to get your quest from. You're in a kind of waiting room, like white walls, cheap plaid-covered armchairs, that sort of a place. There's old motivational posters on the walls. One of them says, motivation, in big, bold letters. And then there's a picture of a chest with a bunch of keys surrounded by a black border. And under motivation, it says, it's usually the last key that opens up the lock.
It's a fantasy world, right?
Yeah.
Why does this office suck? This is like a shitty office we gotta go into. Right?
Yeah. There's some cheap old coffee in the corner.
I get a cup of coffee.
Okay, great.
Thanks. Are there mugs?
There are paper cups.
Paper? They have paper?
Yeah. It's not.
What's the coffee inn?
Or like pre-medieval.
What was the coffee inn?
Was the coffee inn? Like a carafe.
But that's glass or metal?
Yeah.
Okay, I would like to steal the carafe of coffee.
Great. No one's really watching you guys. The receptionist, Betsy, is there, but she's kind of at her desk in the front, and she's just like head down doing some work.
Plus coffee pot.
And you guys are waiting in this waiting room for the proprietor, Tavlin, to come out and give you your temp job for the day.
I eat one of my 10 days worth of rations.
Great. You want to take your pen and mark down that you have 9 days worth of rations on? Wonderful. You guys want to do anything else or talk to each other at all while this is all going on? Or
I'm eating.
You're eating.
Can I talk to the receptionist?
Sure.
Okay. Can I ask if they're that we're probably going to get an assignment, but is there one we should ask for?
Sure. Go ahead and ask
her. Is there? Because I'm figure he's got a job he wants us to do, but you know, like there's got to be a better one. What's the better job?
He doesn't really tell me anything about the job, the contracts that come in. He says he pairs them up to the skills of the adventurers, but I don't know. You can ask if you want.
So are they ranked? Is it like D rank, B rank, A rank, and an A rank is harder than a D rank?
I think they're alphabetically filed by the person who asked for it.
Great, great.
Can I get back to my work, please? Yes. Do you have any other questions?
Nope.
All right, well, you're talking to Betsy, and the door to the inner office starts opening, and a fat little gnome wearing, like, blue robes comes out, and you guys know this is Tavlin Crownbottom, the proprietor of Tavlin's Temporium, LLC, and he's carrying a manila folder, assumably with the contracts in them. He comes in, he says, "Greetings, adventurers! Today, we have quite a heroic task for you. It seems one, let me see here," and he goes through the manila folders. "It seems one Rialta Weathersby is distraught because her daughter has been kidnapped by evil witches. Dear me, she has contracted you to save her girl from these dastardly spell hags. How noble! Huzzah!"
I'd like to grab him and throw him against the wall.
Okay. Right. Do you want to, like, grab him? Because he's small. He's a gnome.
I would like to assault him.
Okay. You're throwing him or, like, putting him up against the wall? Like
I'm going to throw him against the wall.
Okay. So first thing you're going to do is roll a dexterity check to see that if you can just, like, grab him firm enough. Roll your
d20. Great. Okay. That's 17 plus my dexterity, which is 15 plus 2.
Yeah, you grab him.
Great.
So now I'm just going to, you have him. You're going to throw him. I want you to do a strength check just to see if he gets, like, hurt badly by this.
Is that the d20 again?
Yeah, do it again and now add your strength.
Okay. 3 plus 16 plus 3. So 19, 20, 21, 22.
Wait, are you adding the...
Wait, plus 3?
Just the one that has a plus next to
it. Oh, 6. Yeah.
6? Okay, yeah. So you throw him, but it's not quite hard enough to, like, do any real damage. Okay. But he just kind of, like, goes against the wall and goes, "What was that for? What?"
"You sent us on a mission, and I am a were-raccoon now. And you didn't tell us about the dangers of that mission ahead of time? I would like to be paid double for my last mission."
"For the last mission?"
"Yes, the last mission."
"That was weeks ago."
"It doesn't matter. Every morning I have to wake up and fear that I'm going to turn into a were-raccoon because of your bullshit tactics and lack of workman's comp."
"Well, I was not aware that you were such an unskilled adventurer that you would allow yourself to be bit by a were-raccoon."
I draw my battle axe.
I want to use a command on Heather.
Okay.
Or on Cratch.
Yes.
Who's naked except for a skinned were-raccoon, right?
Yep.
I want to command him, "Jack off."
Her.
Oh, it's a. I thought it was a male.
It's a woman. No, Cratch is a woman.
All right, well then, all right.
Jill off.
Jill off. Jill off.
Yeah, you can do that. Great. So for command, I will allow it. For command, Heather, you have to succeed on a wisdom saving throw.
Oh, no.
So go ahead and roll your d20 and add your wisdom.
Okay. That's a 7 minus 1, so that's a 6.
So she's saving against Jimmy's spell save, which is 13. Does not save. You have to obey that command.
Great. Give me a second, because I want you to watch what I'm about to do. She begins to Jill off.
Great.
As she is doing that, because I was annoyed with her, that's why I gave her that command, I turn back to the owner and say, "You were saying."
"Thank you, sir. My, what a vicious assault."
And he's kind of like looking at Cratch because I assume Cratch is still making deep eye contact with him. And he's like creeped out a little bit, but he continues,
"Well, the
Rialta, the woman who made the contract for you today, her house is in the old ward of the city, located at 52 Bleecker Street, if you want to go there. And she'll be able to give you further details on the evil witches holding her daughter. Please stop.
Do you know what's doing this for me? I'm thinking about how I'm gonna kill you.
Oh God, kill me, you won't get paid.
No, I'm gonna get your money.
Do you guys have any other questions you wanted to ask him? You can also just head out if you think you're ready.
No, I don't have any clue. We're going to this house, right? We have the address?
Mm-hmm.
What was the address again?
52 Bleecker Street.
And it's a woman who's got a Bleecker kidnapped Street. Daughter?
Yes, according to the contract he told you, and he gives you a sheet with the address on it, so your characters don't have to worry about remembering it. It was Rialta Weathersby, and she says that her daughter has been kidnapped by witches.
Mm. All right, well, one, I take offense. The way you say witches, like it's a bad thing, because I'm a warlock. All right, so I'm going to take this gig, but I'm not sure whose side I'm on yet.
I meant no offense, but I mean if they...
I took offense.
Well, if they kidnap a child... Okay, all right. Please. Betsy, could you get her some paper towels or something? And Betsy reaches under her desk and gives you a box of tissues.
I throw them at him.
Okay. Do you guys want to head out?
Yeah, so we head out.
I feel like I have to ask, are you still doing it as you leave?
No, or I finish.
You finish?
I finish.
Great. Just making sure. All right. As you're walking out, you see Tavlin motion to the receptionist towards what you left behind, like to clean it up.
I say that guy, you see how I just finished? You're finished when I get back.
Are you propositioning me?
I leave.
So you guys are outside of the temp agency. You're in the streets now. You can kind of go wherever you want. You can go straight to the address if you want. If you want to go somewhere else, like if your character has any errands they want to do or anything, that's fine. It's about 9:15 in the morning. And Calmstone, this city, your characters have lived here, your characters would know. It's kind of like, imagine like a big bustling, think like medieval London style city, or medieval metropolis kind of thing.
Like Bloodborne.
Yeah, kind of like Bloodborne.
Right?
How far away are we from our address?
You guys know, you can probably get to that address in like, if you walk, probably like half hour.
Can I go to the place where I bought the dollhouse, that area, the market?
The market plaza? Yes,
great.
Are you guys all going together?
I'll go to the market plaza.
Okay.
I'm looking for a place where I can buy weapons.
Okay. Are you going also, Miles? You look like you're thinking about it.
I'm annoyed, but I'm going.
Jimmy...
Cratch is always doing this.
Jimmy, Cratch, and... Guaplar 3000 are heading to the Market Plaza. You guys get there, and Market Plaza is a big open plaza. The buildings on the outside that ring it are kind of more permanent stores, structures, that sort of thing. And then in the middle, there's a lot of pop-up stalls, smaller things to get packed up at the end of the day. That's kind of the layout. So Heather, you said you wanted to look for weapons,
yep,
right?
Yep.
Do you want to just like search around in the middle area, or do you want to go to, like, a weapon shop?
A weapon shop.
Okay. So on the outer edge in, like, the southeast corner, there is a permanent weapon shop. You can just go there.
Great. Is there a person working there?
Yes.
Okay, can I ask? I'm looking for an upgrade because I have this battle axe.
Oh,
do you have a weapon that is more a better weapon than this?
Well, let me see that.
No, that's not how that works. You can see it just fine from where.
Well, you want me to inspect it and tell you if we got something better.
If you take this, I'm a were-raccoon. I will turn into a were-raccoon,
okay.
And I will eat you alive.
Listen, I just want to inspect the weapon.
Okay,
you toss it to him.
Yeah.
And he kind of like starts looking at the blade.
We got some nice blades. Nothing that's gonna do much better than this in a fight, but I got a very nice kind of heirloom axe sold by a former noble the other day. He came in. It looks like very good quality, less nicks than this. Someone could sell you for about 50 gold.
How much is that
axe? I want to put a... I asked him if I can see this axe. I want to see this axe.
The one that
he was describing? He was describing. I want to see this heirloom axe.
Oh, you're interested in the axe, too.
I just like to see it.
Don't do this to me. I want the axe.
All right.
He sets your axe on the counter.
I take the axe back. Thank you very much.
I wasn't going to take it. It's a shop. I have no reason to steal from you.
And he goes under the counter and starts rummaging, and he comes back up, and he comes up with a very nice axe. Got, like, a nice jewel at the hilt, at the pommel. It's very nice. It's cleaner. It's probably polished a bit because it's in a store.
And now I want to cast a command on him. Sleep.
You've waited a bit since that last fight. So I'll let you cast that. He has to try and save against it. So I'll tell you this. When you cast command, after he eventually wakes up, he will know that a spell was cast on him. Just so you know, all right?
Okay.
So he's going to say, sorry, let me find his, wasn't expecting to have to roll against that. He actually saves. So he kind of like pauses and like goes glazed-eyed for a second and then kind of shakes it off and says, wait a minute. What were you just doing to me?
I don't know what you're talking about.
And he kind of like slits his eyes and like looks at you guys.
50 what? For this? 50?
50 gold.
50 gold. Okay. I will trade you my axe and 5 gold for this axe.
This axe?
Yes.
Or your axe?
Yeah, my axe for your axe plus 5 gold. This is a 45 gold axe.
That ain't worth 45 gold.
Yes, it is. You just said that this axe is barely better than that one.
No, it's nicer. I just don't
you
know that it
is. You said barely.
I wouldn't do much better in a fight.
Oh, exactly.
But as a display piece, it's much nicer.
I don't want a display piece. I want a better axe.
Look, you know what? I don't know if I let you. You're coming in here, and he's doing something with me. And
so he seems very against bartering because of being very put off of, like, some kind of spell being cast on him.
I want to do some thaumaturgy. I want to throw a voice from behind him that says, sell her the axe.
And we'll say,
who was that?
He's gonna roll to see like if he thinks that's a real person or if he kind of has the idea that you're doing magic stuff again. No, he doesn't know what's going on with that. So he's kind of like spinning around, looking around him. You guys hear that?
Yeah, it sounded like your boss. 45.
I own this shop.
Yeah, but I don't know who sounds like an authority figure. Maybe it was the police, because they think you might be up to some shady, underhanded black market weapons dealing.
Well, did you see any guards coming in when you were coming in here?
I didn't.
You all but admitted what she just said is true. By the way, you said that.
My axe, so, plus 5 gold for that axe, and we can just walk out of here. You look kind of sleepy, so I'm worried about it.
I throw that voice behind him again. It says, do it or die.
He kind of starts again and says, all right, fine,
great.
Fine.
There.
And he just makes that change. So you have no money.
But.
And an axe, which the axe is nicer and it's worth a bit more. Does not change the stats of the axe.
Bullshit.
That blows.
But it is worth more if you eventually try to sell it again.
All that work.
Do I know of any other weapons shops in town?
This is like the only permanent weapons shop. Yeah. There are probably places in the area in the center of the market that have all those like pop-up stalls. Like they sell all kinds of stuff in there. Mm. You could go and look around in there, but that's a little less for sure if you'll find what you're looking for.
Are there weapons that she can get that will upgrade her stats?
If you spend some time looking, you might find something.
Great, let's go look for fucking Jesus.
You got a nicer axe.
Yeah, I'm gonna go. I want a better weapon. This is just a fancy weapon.
Well, actually, but it's worth more.
Yeah, so I'll sell it and get a better weapon.
Is there a shop around here where I can go look at jewelry?
Yeah, there's a jewelry shop.
I want to go there.
Okay. So let's do
it. No one wants. Yeah. I don't want to go with him. I don't have jewelry.
I want to go. I'll go.
You're going to go too? All right. So you guys go and you go into like a permanent not what the shops in the center. I'm just going to keep calling them those because those work a little different.
I'm following, but I'm like 20 yards behind.
The equivalent of like bored and on your phone. The jewelry shop is like on the other side, and you go there. You go in, and there's like there's a high elf behind the counter. And he's very like little snooty looking, and he's just standing there like brushing off a little dust from the counter. Hello, sir.
Hey, look, I'm a human sorcerer, and I'm looking for a chain with, like, a lightning bolt pendant on it. I just got a job, so I'm coming into some money, so I figure I want to fawn it a little bit.
Well, very well. A lightning bolt chain.
Well, the chain, but the pendant on it is a lightning bolt. You know,
yes,
to signify that my sorcery.
Mm-hmm. Are you looking for any particular material or jewels?
Probably just regular gold. You know, just keep it simple.
So both the chain and the pendant itself?
Yes, both gold.
Well, let me look in back. Would you wait just a moment, please?
Oh, yeah.
And he goes back. There are guards at the front of this shop, just so you know.
Can I take some practice swings with my axe to make sure that it's no different?
Inside the shop?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Just roll a dexterity check to see if you are able to not hit.
Is that D20?
Yeah. I assume you're not trying to hit.
No, I'm not trying to hit anything. Okay. That is a 9 plus 2.
Okay. So you don't hit anything.
Right.
Yeah, it feels pretty good.
That's good. Yes.
So he comes back out.
I go out into the center of the square, and I use thaumaturgy again. Which makes my voice boom 3 times as loud as it normally would for a minute. And I start screaming, who has the best two-handed weapon?
So you do that real fast. I'll get back to this guy coming back at you. You do that, and all of a sudden you hear just a like so many vendors like clamoring, like, I do. Oh, you want to come over here, sir? You should come over here. Come check my wares, sir. Over here, I have the greatest. And just a cacophony of market people trying to convince you that they have the best two-handed weapons.
All right, now I start cursing. Shut up. No, shut up.
So, Ronnie, the guy comes out and he says, Wilson, I have a sterling silver necklace with a small lightning bolt. I could change it out for a gold. However, the only pendant we have. Your friend, all right.
Oh, yeah, she's just doing practice swings. We got a big mission coming up after this, so gotta stay ready.
Sir, would you mind stepping outside with your battle axe?
Oh, so you can rob my friend? No, I'll stay right here. Thank you very much.
I come into the store now, and I use thaumaturgy. To make the door slam shut behind me.
Okay. So he sees us all going on, and he kind of like shakes his head. He's probably a little used to adventurers coming in. So he says like he basically has the pendant that he has is sterling silver. He doesn't have a gold lightning bolt.
But the chain is gold.
He can switch it out for a gold chain, yes.
Okay, then I'll take that.
Okay. Well, excellent, sir. I'm glad you're pleased. This will come up to, with labor for changing out the chain, this would be approximately 25 gold.
25 gold, huh? Okay, well, I don't have that exactly. Like I said, I got the job today. So
I could put it on layaway for you if you'd like.
How about this? Huh. I mean, I got some stuff like, you like torches? I get you a couple torches.
No, sir. I'm not a particular fan of torches.
I use thaumaturgy to create the illusion of 25 gold being placed on the counter in front of him.
He stares at it for a sec, reaches out and takes it, and his hand goes through the illusion.
Are you a ghost?
Whoa!
Hey! Hey! Whoa. What'd you do to my gold? What'd you just do to my gold?
Go ahead and roll a deception check to try and convince him of that. So you're going to roll your d20. I think your character... No, you're not trained. So you're going to add your charisma, so +3 to that.
12 plus 3 is
15. 15. You're not able, it would be really hard. You're not able to convince him that he's a ghost. Sir, please, I'm not an idiot.
Well, what'd you do to my gold,
yeah,
though?
That's awfully
I put it
spooky.
On the counter, and then you put your hands right through it.
Let's see you try to pick it up, sir.
I use thaumaturgy. And it appears that I pick up the gold and put it back down.
Roll another deception.
Ah, 7.
7 plus 3 is 10. Ten. Oh, God, it's still not... It's getting easier when you do that, but he's still not going to... So he says... He turns back to you and he says, sir, I'm not sure what your friends are trying to do with their little cantrippy spells. Mm. However, if you are truly interested in this unique piece, I can put it on layaway for you. You said you were completing a big job today?
Mm-hmm. Look, how about this? I'll let you put it on layaway, but I'm not paying 25
You'll
gold
let
for.
Me put it on layaway.
Yeah,
you heard him.
Yes. And let's say 15 gold because you're a ghost trying to deceive me. And then I'll come back afterwards and get this.
This whole time I'm constantly picking up down the gold.
Roll persuasion check. So you're trying to persuade him that this is a good deal.
Which one is that?
That is, roll your d20. Mm-hmm. You're going to add your charisma, and you are trained in persuasion. So you're going to add +6 to that.
Oh, +6? So then that's 10. I got a 4.
Because it's a +6, you actually manage him. He says, he doesn't give you 15, but he says, I can go down to 20 gold.
Hmm. Okay. 17 gold and a torch.
I really don't need a torch.
Okay, then 15 gold and a traveler's rope.
18 gold, sir, and that's my final offer.
How about this? If you hear about what we did today and how we saved this town from a bunch of witches and that gets around to you, then I think maybe you should give the man a deal since we helped our village.
Okay. We'll say 20 gold, and if I hear about your exploits and how it saved my shop, then I'll go down to 15
gold. I used thaumaturgy, and I put a voice behind him that starts explaining our exploits. And what great heroes we are.
Describe what the voice says.
These guys, they saved the town. they saved some girl from some witches. And just give him the necklace. He deserves it.
I'm going to see if he's convinced by this. He rolled a 2. So he turns around and he goes, Wilbur? Sorry, I think my shopkeep may have been speaking to me.
Yeah, he was speaking to you. I heard him, then he ran off.
Well, all right, we'll say if you can come back with 15 gold, I'll give you that necklace. Right. Very well.
All right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Good job. Right. Good
well,
day.
What time are you guys close?
Hey.
5:30.
Mm. You know what? We're going to find the man that killed you.
I still don't believe I'm a ghost, but thank you for the offer.
No, him picking up his coin says differently.
I pick up the 25 gold, seem to put it in my pocket.
So. Great.
So at this point, you guys have been to 2 stores, been to bartered at both of them. It's like 10.
Right. Mm-hmm. Can we run at top speed to 52 Bleecker Street?
Yeah, if you run there... it'll be like 20 minutes instead of 30. It's not a huge difference. What were you going to say, Miles? It looked like you were going to say something.
Did we want to try and get you a better weapon?
This weapon's fine. I killed a lot of people with that other weapon.
Well, this fucking
basically
square
same.
Is full of liars because I yelled for who's got the best
it's all right.
weapon, and they all said they did.
That means a lot to me. And my daughter.
Oh, don't start that.
So what do you guys want to do?
I want to go to Bleecker Street. Let's kill some witches.
All right. Yeah. Okay, great. So you guys spend like 20 minutes running over to Bleecker Street. And you get to the address that Tavlin gave you. Here we go. And you find yourself in kind of more of a residential neighborhood of the city. The address looks like a nice, cozy little home. It's not, it's like upper middle class. And yeah, it's a nice little house. What do you're in front of it.
I attempt to use thaumaturgy on the front door to open it.
The door is locked, so it doesn't fly open.
So I turn to these guys and say, the door is locked.
Okay.
Because I tried to open it with thaumaturgy.
Can I knock? Can I
knock?
Yep.
And you hear a woman's voice kind of say, call out like from another room, just a moment, please. And a second later, she comes and you hear deadbolt undoing. She opens the door, and it's...
Before she can open it, I use thaumaturgy to fly, to fling the door open now that it's unlocked.
Door hits her in the face. she does not dodge in time, and you hear, like, as it's flying open, you just hear a bit of a clunk, and it, like, does that thing of, like, rebounding a little.
I wasn't trying to hurt her. I was just trying to make the door fly open real fast.
She was standing right there. She tried to dodge. I saw it. She just was very slow. And she goes, oof, oh, my.
So sorry. It's really windy out here.
Yeah. And she finishes opening, and you see it's a middle-aged woman, and she looks like she hasn't really, like, done her hair lately or anything. She looks very, like, anxious and fretting. And also, just quick pause, I'm gonna give a little recap, because apparently I've been told we got some new viewers. So, if you just joined us, just to give you a quick recap of what's going on so far, these guys have gotten a quest. This woman that they've just hit in the face with a door is, on accident, you didn't, true, is hired them because her daughter was kidnapped by witches. They got that job this morning. It's now about 10:30. And because they spent a good chunk of the morning so far bartering for a new axe and a lightning bolt pendant necklace that is now on layaway. And also just generally tricking shopkeeps. So that's where we're at now. They just got to the location of the job.
Can I ask this woman for water? Because we just ran here for 20 minutes.
So as soon as the door opens, you ask for water, and she immediately goes like, I'm sorry, who are you?
We're here because some of us have suffered a loss like yours. And
oh, are you from the temp agency?
Yeah.
Oh, wonderful. Please, come in.
First,
sorry about that door thing. I didn't mean to hit you with the door.
Oh, that was you. I thought it was the wind.
You're right. It was the wind. It was the wind.
A couple of things. I would encourage you next time to find a different temp agency if you ever have a problem, because that one needlessly puts its adventurers in danger.
Are you saying you won't help me?
No, we're here to help, but just consider other agencies in the future.
Oh, okay. Thank you for that advice.
You're welcome.
She kind of turns to you and says, I'm sorry, you said you wanted a water?
Yes, please.
Water?
Do you still have that coffee pot?
Yeah, you still have the coffee pot.
I forgot you took that. Don't forget to add craft to your equipment.
I have it.
Okay, great. What are you?
No, I'm just curious if you still have some coffee. I want some coffee.
All right, you can have some of my coffee.
Oh, I can make fresh coffee if you'd like.
I drink out of the craft. And it's clear that I'm like sort of spitting back into it. Because my mouth doesn't quite work well, so I can give it back to the tanks.
Wait, you're like a pug?
Like I'm part lizard something.
All right, so she kind of sees that happening and nods a little and says, I'll go get your water. She steps into the other room to
go. I want to investigate the room.
Sure, roll a d20 for an investigation check. And I'll start describing. The room you're in is a living room. There's like a mantle. There's a small painting. It's not a huge thing, but there's a small painting that seems to be of the woman you just met, who's a little younger in the painting, a man standing next to her, and a, sorry, I'm doing math in my head. This probably would have been a, like, 15-year-old girl.
Mm. It's a wisdom check, or what is it for investigation?
Investigation is intelligence.
So I have a 6.
You look around grimly, nod your head, and think, Looks like a living room.
We should trust this woman. There's absolutely nothing suspicious about this house.
You're an idiot. I now investigate the room.
So roll your d20. Add your intelligence.
It's a 19 plus a 15, or plus 2, 21.
21, all right. So you, as you're investigating, you kind of look around, and she's going to come back soon, but you're quick enough about this to be able to, like, kind of, you know, like, check in a few drawers. You're not, like, stealing things necessarily, but you know, look if there's anything interesting.
The whole time I'm doing it, I'm looking at her like she's an idiot.
So you don't find too much. There's that, the painting that any of you could see. In the drawers, there's maybe like a couple, like, notepads. There's really not much interesting. As you're looking around, you get the sense that the furniture is maybe a little more budget than you would expect in this upper middle class. Like, maybe they've had to downgrade the furniture or the furnishings of the room a few times. But you rolled well enough that you can tell that at a glance. That's all you get, yeah.
Can I use my dagger to carve D3000 in the desk?
In the desk?
Initially, yeah.
You can start doing that. As you're starting to carve, you do hear her coming back. You hear footsteps coming back.
Okay. I just go faster. It's just 3,000.
So if this is the desk, are you doing it like right on the corner or like on the side or like?
Probably somewhere more on the side.
Okay, great. So you get which initials? G3000.
G3000.
Great. That is carved with a dagger in her wooden desk.
As he's doing that, I'm explaining to Cratch what I noticed about the furniture. That it seems like it's been like they had to scale back on the price of the furniture in here.
Okay.
That I find that slightly suspicious.
Okay. Great.
So she comes back in with glass and hands it to you. So please, are you going to help me find my daughter?
Yes.
What's up with the furniture? Huh? What's up with the furniture? Why is the furniture not as nice as the place should dictate it is?
Oh my, is it that obvious?
Yeah.
Yes, to me it is.
I noticed it.
No, you did not.
Well, ever since my husband died, we've been living off of the insurance money, and, you know, sometimes things get tight, and we've slowly had to sell some of the furniture and replace it with cheaper pieces. I really thought I did a better job of making it flow in the room and work a little better. I guess it's good to know that it's so obvious to a stranger coming into my house.
Don't you be ashamed of who you are. You're doing the best with what you have.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Welcome.
She's getting a little teary.
Is she wearing any rings?
She's wearing a wedding ring, but she also just said that her husband died. Seems like it might be sentimental.
As I pull my hand away, I attempt to slip her ring off her finger.
That'll be a sleight of hand check, so you're going to add your dexterity
right
to it.
The 20?
Yep.
Five plus one.
Plus one, a six. You are not able, you're basically, it's like the equivalent of like, your hand like catches for a moment on the ring, but it's such like a bad attempt, she doesn't even think you're attempting. Like, she just thinks you're clumsy about taking your hand away. She can't, all right.
Oh yes, I'm sorry.
I asked her, does she have any beef stew?
Beef stew? No, I don't have any prepared.
Well, do you have anything to eat?
I could find something, I'm sure. Do you want to know anything about the witches who have kidnapped my daughter?
We do.
Definitely. But after you make something to eat for us. I mean, my friend right here, he's already down a ration pack, and I don't want to start using my own.
All right, I'll be right back.
Thank you.
Okay, she goes into the kitchen again.
That was a good move. I'm hungry.
Yeah, I thought so. I'm just looking out for you.
Can I go upstairs?
Sure.
Great.
Yeah, there's
Look if I can find this daughter's room.
Okay. It's upstairs isn't huge. It's not a huge second floor. There's only like three doors. We'll say it's three, like 1, 2, 3 clockwise from you. Which one do you want?
Second one.
So that is a bathroom.
Okay, check the first one.
That is a bedroom. You want to investigate to see if you can tell, or are you just trying to see at a glance what you see?
Does it look like a kid's bedroom?
It doesn't look like a kid's bedroom. It looks like maybe it's a little messy. It doesn't look like an adult's bedroom, maybe like a young adult's bedroom.
Okay, great.
Like, it's got a couple piles of clothing. Mm-hmm. It does, like, the bedding is made. It doesn't look like it's been slept in a while.
Okay, can I do an investigation? Great. Okay, that's an 18 plus what?
Intelligence?
18.
So you look around and you find, it seems like, other than the clothes in the corner, it seems like nothing else has been like moved lately. There's actually like dust on the desk and the nightstand too. There's like there's like some jewelry on the nightstand, but that's dust covered. Also, like the stuff that would normally get picked up a lot on the nightstand is covered in dust.
Is there like a Dungeons and Dragons equivalent of like a portrait? Like a little painting or something, like a photo would be.
You mean like the one you saw in the living room downstairs?
Yeah, but of her at her normal current age.
No, there's no paintings in here.
There's no image of this like a woodcut, a stamp.
No, not rug. In this room.
Okay, great.
While Cratch is in the room looking around, can I bust in there and then do a swan dive on the bed, like to lighten the mood?
Sure. Are you trying to like surprise her, or are you just doing it?
A little bit of both.
All right, so do a stealth check.
What's the D20?
Yeah, roll that. And I don't believe you're trained.
Oh no! Oh no!
What did you get?
A one.
Okay, so you are running up the stairs to this because you were still downstairs, and you just trip on the top step. Real bad. And now,
oh shit! Oh.
Roll a dexterity check to see how badly you fall.
Six.
Six.
Minus one.
Five.
So roll a the D4. You hit
this one?
Yeah, you hit your face real hard on the no, it's the triangle. Yeah. Roll that. You take one damage. So you're down to 10 hit points. Yeah. You fall like face first on a corner of a step and hit your cheek. So you don't swan dive on the bed and you don't sneak up on Cratch because
but I hear this, right?
You hear that.
I run out and I'm like, hey, are you okay? Are you okay? Did she attack you?
Yeah, no. I was trying to be playful and I ended up tripping on the top of the stairs and hitting my face.
All right.
I think I'm down a hit point. I don't know.
Still in the living room just looking at the furniture.
So she comes back in, you're staring at the furniture. So she comes out. Previously, there were three people who were going to save her daughter. And she comes out and carrying like a bowl of crackers. And there's one of them staring at her couch. She stands up and says, oh, where did everybody else go? I brought crackers.
I use thaumaturgy to create the illusion that those two are standing right next to me, just as they were before.
So from her perspective, apparitions just appear. And she goes, ah, ah! And she does not drop the bowl of chips or crackers.
And I ask her, what's your daughter's name and how old is she?
My daughter's name is Naya. And she just turned 22.
Just turned 22, and mm-hmm. she was taken by witches. Mm-hmm. How old was she when she was taken by witches?
Oh, last time I saw her was about a month and a half ago.
So she's about two, so this is recent?
Yes, very recent.
Are the witches in the house?
No, I have an address of their witch hut, if you want to go there.
I'm downstairs by now, I assume?
You're heading down?
Yeah.
Are you coming down too?
I'm still upstairs, and even though she sees the apparitions, you hear me yell from the top of the stairs, do you have any bandages up here?
She looks up, and she notices that glass of water is sitting on a stand untouched. And she looks up, and says like,
oh, yes, I think in the medicine cabinet in the bathroom, it's the third door from your left clockwise. You wanted those water still, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna drink it.
Okay, I brought some crackers down too.
Oh, okay, put that beside the water.
Okay, did something happen that he needs bandages?
Yeah, I think there might have been a ghost or something.
I think there was a ghost on the stairs. I start eating the beef stew.
Well, it's just crackers.
It's just crackers.
Oh, it's crackers.
Yeah, it's not stew.
I thought you said a bowl.
He asked for stew. She didn't have beef stew just randomly prepared.
Okay.
But she brought crackers up.
All right.
I took liberty of looking for a photo of or image of your daughter. Do you have what she looks like? Or is this the most recent portrait?
You motion at the one up there. Yeah, she says, this is from about 6 years ago when my husband was still alive. More recently...
What happened to your husband?
Bandits. He was killed by bandits on a... He was on a merchant trip.
That's gotta be rough, losing your husband and your daughter. I want you to know...
He's on a merchant trip? What did he do?
He traded silks with another city to the east.
Really?
I'm not allowed in that city.
Oh, you're allowed in that city?
I didn't say which city it was.
I'm not allowed in that city. I know that city.
Which city are you not allowed in?
There's a city directly to the east where they have a lot of silk scarves and
stuff.
Yeah,
say the name of the city.
Why? Do you not know it? Are you trying to trick me?
Well, I'm trying to tell if it's...
I'm not a bandit. If that's what you're trying to imply is that I'm the bandit that killed your
husband.
No,
I'm not trying to imply anything. I'm just trying to see if it generally... You really knew, just pure guess, which city he went to.
What other city would it be other than the one that's directly to the east?
I don't... There could be any number of cities to the east.
Are you... What is your
I'm
deal,
sorry.
Lady?
I just thought it was very strange that you just assumed...
We're here to save your daughter, and you're
I'm
grilling
sorry.
Me about my
you're
issues
right.
with the map?
You're right. I'm just... I'm.
The two of you, shut up. Give me the address for where the witches are.
Why do you know where the witches live?
Because she visited me once. They let her come visit, and she I think they bewitched her to come back to them.
You...
Wait a minute. Your daughter, who was taken, visits you?
Only once.
So your daughter got kidnapped by witches, came back, and then you just let her go again?
I didn't let her go. She stormed out.
So she came,
told
you the...
That's not a kidnapping, then. She stormed out.
She came, told you the address, and then left?
Your kid moved out.
No, I'm sure they bewitched her.
Uh-huh. What evidence do you have of this bewitching?
Why would my little girl leave the house?
Look at the shitty furniture you got. She grew up with nice things, and now you got this fucking fold-away bed here?
Why would she come back at all to just tell you the address of a witch's coven?
She was telling me that the witches were wonderful and that I should come by sometime, and she said that they thought that I was... Not
your daughter became a witch.
This is not an abduction at all. Your daughter moved out and moved in with some other ladies, all right?
You're paying us to
go forcibly remove someone from their place of residence against their will.
I want to grab this woman.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to grab this woman.
Do a strength check.
Okay. I have a... 6 plus 3, so 9.
9? So you kind of like grab her by the collar, but she's able to yank away. Now listen. I'm hiring you.
You listen. I actually lost my daughter. She's buried in a cemetery outside of town.
Oh,
and
that's awful.
You are mad about your daughter taking up with people you don't respect or love. That's not a kidnapping. That's just a disagreement.
The last time I saw her was during after the first week she was gone, and I have not seen her since.
I'm gonna punch this woman in the throat.
I have not seen my daughter for over 5 weeks.
How did you get?
16 for what? What's the check?
Oh, it's strength, but a 16 will hit her.
Yeah, punch her in the throat.
I turn to Guapar and say, by the way, there's your beef stew. I point at the bowl of crackers.
I look not amused, but then eat crackers anyway while drinking this water.
Great. You don't have to roll to eat or drink. You punch her. Where did you say you're?
In the throat.
Yeah. So she takes a point of damage, and she kind of coughs. Please, what are you doing?
You are making fun of all the mothers who have actually lost their daughters. If I go to this witch place and she's happy there, I'm going to come back and I'm going to kill you. Then I'm going to burn down your house.
I don't think there's any way she'd be... Look. Would you please at least investigate? I'm certain that they have her under some sort of bewitching spell or fed her a potion or something. It just is uncharacteristic of my daughter to leave without talking to me for so long.
She's an adult, and if I find out that she's happy there, I'm going to kill you.
Would you please at least investigate to see if she's been bewitched?
Fine. Give us the address.
Fine. Don't know why that was so difficult and why you punched
me. Because of everything you said. That's why it was difficult.
Well,
you said your daughter.
You don't know my relationship with my daughter.
I do from what you told me.
I don't believe she's happy.
I use thaumaturgy to make my voice 3 times as loud as it normally is as I yell at this woman everything she just told us.
She shrinks back and is kind of scared.
Look, it's the address is.
I have the address written down. 10687 Mill Lane.
Okay.
You guys write it on the same piece of paper Tavlin gave you with her address. So she gives you the address.
I would like to take 2 chairs from this living room.
You want to take 2 chairs?
Yep.
I'll tell you this. They're not folding, and they're not small enough you could fit them in any sort of backpack.
You
just want to take.
Take 2 chairs.
Are you just like dragging them outside?
Uh-huh.
Or? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Roll a strength check.
Okay. Okay, 6 plus 3, 9.
So if you're trying to take two at once, yeah, you can carry one.
Great, take one chair.
What are you doing?
Shut up and stay where you are.
Please.
I'm looking for the back door.
You're looking for the back door?
Yep.
So you're trying to drag the living room through the hallway in the kitchen. The chair, the armrests are like a little wide, and so if you want to get it through the hallway, it's going to be one of those like you kind of have to like.
Fine by me.
So you're moving this chair through her hallway.
Can you make sure she doesn't go anywhere?
I'm now looking at Crash like, what the fuck? What the fuck are you doing?
Just give me a second.
All right, I'll make sure she doesn't go anywhere.
Please don't take my chair.
I'm not taking it.
You shut up.
You know what? I'm going to take your advice and not hire this temp agency
again. Good, because they keep sending us on these bullshit missions. Last time I got turned into a raccoon, this time you don't even have a kidnapped daughter. Where's your back door?
What are you doing with that chair?
Where's the back door?
So it's at, the hallway leads into the kitchen and there's a back door in
there. Great. I unlock the back door.
I use thaumaturgy to make it fly open.
Is there space in between these buildings or are they like, is there any gangway space in between these buildings?
Like a small alley thing? Yeah, there's a little space in between the buildings.
I'm going to shove the chair underneath the door from the outside so that it cannot be opened.
Mm-hmm.
Great. And then I'm going to walk down the alley to the front door, get the second chair, and be like, all right, guys, let's get out of here.
Wait, what are you doing with the second chair?
I'm going to lock the front door so she can't leave.
Okay. All right, great. So she's like a very like anxious, fretting middle-aged woman. So she's not really doing anything to stop you, but she kind of is continually protesting, be like, I am outraged by this. I can't believe you would treat me like this.
I am outraged by the way you've treated us, especially since I've actually lost my daughter.
I said I'm terribly sorry.
As she's talking, I make the door slam shut in her face because we're outside.
Yeah. I shove the chair underneath the door.
Great.
And I go, I get it.
Yeah.
So you guys just finished locking this woman in her house.
Yep.
She gave you the address. What do you want to do now?
Let's head over to this address,
man.
Let's
go find out how happy this daughter is to be a newly new witch, probably taking lessons.
She's having a good time. And again, I don't like the way people are throwing witch around like it's a bad thing.
Yeah.
All right, we're not all bad things.
Yeah. Great. So you guys are heading over to the address she gave you. Uh-huh. Seems like a good spot. We're gonna take a quick break. We'll do a recap if you're just joining us recently. When we come back from the break, we'll do a quick recap of what's happened so far, including how they stole this woman's furniture. Not really stole, just locked her in using her own furniture. We've got a poll up right now. If you're on twitch.tv watching us, if you want to vote on whether these guys are going to succeed in this quest, go to jash.com/play. You can vote there, and we'll be right back. Hey guys, welcome back to Aristocrits. We are here once again with Ronnie Adrian, Miles Stroth, and Heather Campbell. And we just saw the results of the poll where apparently 82% of you think that these guys are going to fail this quest. We'll see. We'll see.
That's there's no faith.
If you are just joining us, just a quick recap. They were given a quest. Hired by a woman to save her daughter who was kidnapped by witches. They went to her house, and this very anxious older woman basically made it apparent to them that her daughter moved out, and they were not happy about it, decided to lock her in her own home by wedging chairs into all the doorknobs. And now they're going to investigate to see if the young lady, is actually bewitched in some way, or if she just moved out and doesn't want to deal with her crazy mom.
That's what it sounded like.
It's what it sounded like. Also, real fast, we want to give a shout out in the chat to Dream Punch and PUJ33 or Pooj33. I don't know how you pronounce your username. Thanks, guys. We've also been told, haven't seen any yet, but we've been told a lot of people are making GIFs. And I'm very excited to see those. And then before we get back in, guys, we always like to, when we come back from the break, do a quick little question just for all the guests to answer. Because I'm always curious what your guys' previous experience with D&D was, or if you haven't played, like I believe neither of you have, What did you think D&D was versus like what we're doing now? Either you can go.
I don't know. I thought it was like a game where it is like, where it's like, okay, well, now you have, you know, warlocks and orcs and all that stuff, and then it's just like you're walking around, and then at some point you're fighting somebody, but I don't know how it works. So it's like, eight. Oh, with an eight, I hit you with my battle axe. How many, you know, some weird shit like
you
that.
You thought everybody's voice rised a few octaves.
Yeah, I mean, that's how I think of nerds.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was more like the game Magic.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've got a few other guests have thought that, yeah.
Yeah, this, I saw it was more just like, you know, all right, here's my power versus your power.
Uh-huh.
Eventually you accumulate more powers. This is just like playing. It's,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like improvising, except you know all the secrets.
Yeah, yeah. Great. And then Heather, obviously you've been on before, you've played. Remind me, just, and if we've got any new viewers, how long have you been playing?
I've been playing since high school.
Nerd.
I love D&D. It's just fucking awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, I'm just going to say, Heather's like getting the Twitch app to jump into the chat. She's not just randomly on her phone. I was just like, oh, yeah, to anybody who didn't hear what we were talking about. It's just like...
Whatever, yeah. Dungeons & Dragons, I love this game.
All right, guys, let's get back into it. You guys were just leaving her house and going to the address she gave you. Go ahead.
As we go on our trip, can I show them that I took the dusty jewelry off her daughter's dresser?
Sure.
And now I'm showing them that.
No one was up there, so you wouldn't have had to roll for that anyways. Yeah.
So I told showing them I took it. But not because I was stealing, mm-hmm. but because like it's good to have a keepsake of someone that you're going to like see. It's like, I don't know, so you can, mm-hmm. I don't know that. You know, like, because they
personal
touched it.
Connection.
Yeah, it's like, oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and you can tell them that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So, anyway, I took that jewelry off the dresser.
There was jewelry up there? I didn't go up.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It was dusty jewelry. Like,
I tried to get that old ring off her finger, and I screwed it up.
Yeah, you missed it. Should have went exploring. Should have went exploring.
Well, it's your jewelry if we get there, and this is just, like, a college experience for her daughter.
So. Okay. So as you guys are having this conversation, you're walking to this address. It's kind of taking you across town. And as you're going, you kind of notice that you're getting into like a seedier part of town.
Mm-hmm. It's my favorite part of town.
Yeah. You're kind of entering a place like just like in between the industrial district and Hex Row. And you get out there and it's kind of like the boondocks of the town. And the address leads you to a building with a large, magically glowing sign that just says, "The Witch's Hut." And you see a banner on one side that says, "Witches, witches, witches!" And a banner on the other side that says, "Lunch buffet, $5.
This is a strip club. This is a witch strip club.
Mm. You're shitting me.
Her daughter just became a dancer? I'm gonna burn down her house.
Is this the address? Is this the address we were given?
You double check. You look at the sheet. You wrote it down. And I like look up, and this is the address.
It's like, all right.
Well, before we go back and burn the house down, let's just go check it out and see what's inside. Like, see what it's like.
So there's a really big orc bouncer at the front. He's kind of leaning against the door frame and looking bored. There's not really. It's like at this point, it's like, because you were at her place for a bit. You like walked across town. So it's like 11:30 now.
How much do they pay you?
You're talking to the bouncer?
Yeah.
So he kind of like looks at you and says, "Enough."
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You coming in?
Yeah. But how much they pay you?
I'm not going to tell you how much they pay me.
What if I told you that I had a lot of money on me? What's a lot of money to you?
What's a lot of money?
Yeah, what's a lot of money? What would make your day?
The cover's $2. If you're trying to bribe me to get in, I don't know there's no one else in line here, lady.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I use thaumaturgy to hand him $6.
Six gold? Six dollars?
Yeah, you said dollars. I assume you meant gold.
Did I? Sorry. Are you, you mean you're making an illusion again?
Yeah.
So it drops in. The illusion with thaumaturgy, it doesn't hold up to like inspection. So like when it drops in his hand, it doesn't even feel like there's any weight. It's like a hologram. Think of it. So it goes in his hand and he's like, and he like does that. Same thing and his hand goes through it. And he's like, he kind of gives you a really look.
What kind of club is this?
It's a gentleman's club.
But it's a witch-only gentleman's club?
No, the witches are the entertainers, and it's owned by a coven.
The sign out front isn't for who you want to come in. You moron.
I know.
Strip clubs don't say John's.
I use my friend's power on the orc.
Okay. Yeah, you do have that.
Yeah.
Awesome.
So basically, so you cast that friends on him. So basically, if you want to like convince him of anything or ask him any questions, basically anything you do that would require a charisma check, so like persuade him, intimidate him, mm-hmm. any of that sort of stuff, you have advantage on. All that means is anytime you roll the d20 for those checks, you roll it twice and use the higher number.
Okay. Yeah. So I want to persuade him to let me and my friends in for free.
Okay, so roll your d20 and roll it twice and use the higher and kind of tell me what you're saying to him.
And that was 14. And that was two. So the 14. 14.
And you add 4 to that. And I think you might be, yeah, you're trained in persuasion. So you actually add 6 to it. So 20. And so what are you saying to him?
Hey, man, look, you seem like a cool dude. I mean, and we're cool as well. And we're just trying to go in and see what the place is like. So how about you just come and just let us slide on these two gold coins each?
And he kind of like looks up and down the street and he's like,
look, it's 11:30. No one's here.
Like, the lunch buffet crowd hasn't started yet. So yeah, go ahead, go in.
Thanks so much.
Thanks, man.
If you would have given me the number, I would have given you the number back, if you know what I mean.
What's her deal?
You don't want to know, man. Well, maybe okay. You do. I don't know. You know.
I'm okay.
Okay. All right. Well.
So yeah, he like lets you guys in.
Mm-hmm. Great. What do we see?
So you walk in. It's sort of like kind of like a darker hallway as you go in, and like the door doesn't immediately open in, probably so that blinding daylight doesn't hit any of the people who are actually in this at 11:30. And once you go through kind of like the velvet curtain at the end of that small hallway, you kind of see, it's clearly a strip club.
Okay.
You enter and you see a stage at the back of the room, and there's no one dancing or anything on it right now, but there is an older bard just tuning an instrument on there. There's no one on the stage. To the left, against one wall, there's a buffet island that's got like mutton and chicken, owlbear steaks, salad, you know, buffet type things. Mm-hmm. And then to your right is a bar, and there's kind of a middle-aged human woman behind it. She has a sweet, almost stereotypically motherly face, like that sort of like stereotypical like medieval like plump kind of friendly face. Mm-hmm. She's working behind the bar. And she beams at you as soon as you walk in and gives you a big smile. And there's a drunken dwarf at one end of the bar at 11:30 in the morning with his face is just down on the bar.
I go to the bar.
Okay.
I also go to the bar.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And she says, welcome, dearies. Come on in. Bit early, but if you want to pay for the lunch buffet now, you'll be ready when Yaza brings it out. How is your day going?
It's great. You like working here?
Oh, yes. It's wonderful.
How long have you been here? How long have you been here?
Oh, my sisters and I have been here for, about 40 years now.
Oh, okay.
Yo, is Naya around? Naya?
Oh, I don't know a Naya.
You don't?
Is that the girl's name?
I don't know.
Yeah, it was. The daughter's name was Naya.
Naya.
Naya right. Weathersby.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Naya's Weathersby?
Was her name.
I'm asking this woman.
Naya Weathersby.
Doesn't
ring a bell.
Mm-hmm. Maybe that woman just has a problem with strip clubs and we should just go back and burn her house down.
Wait, Patch. I mean, I feel like you're gonna do that anyway.
No, I'm not.
Okay.
Do you guys want a drink while you wait for the entertainment to start?
Yes.
Yeah, what you got?
Well, we've got mead, we've got harder alcohols, harder spirits, if you desire. We also have some non-alcoholic stuff, as we're required to serve by the Greater Calmstone Council of Mages.
You like those guys?
Who?
They always giving you trouble?
The Council of Mages?
Yeah.
Well, we've had their issues. Mages aren't the most accepting of witches.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like there should be a better representative democracy in town? Because I feel like, because I've had this problem before, you know, like when you're a barbarian, there's very few barbarians in government, Mm-hmm. And so they're like,
I'll take some mead.
Mead? One mead?
And some hard stuff.
And some hard, ooh.
I want a Boilermaker.
Oh, all right. And she starts prepping that for you.
I will also take some mead.
Great.
And then I use my friend spell on this woman.
Okay. And what are you going to do?
Hey.
I thought you were going to
Look, I'm sorry. You've been working here for how long?
40 years.
I can't believe that. You look a day over 20 years old.
Oh, dear, you are trying to seduce me, aren't you?
Is it that transparent? I'm not trying. We're on a mission right now, so obviously I can't mix business with pleasure, but...
Ooh, a mission.
Yeah, ooh. Yeah, it's a real big one.
So hey, look, witch, mead.
She's pouring while she's talking like this. Hey,
forgive my aggressive friend. Okay. Look.
And she, she's talking, she sets two meads down and she goes to start prepping the harder stuff.
So look, you know, can you do me and my friends a solid here and just kind of give us these pro bono, you know, meaning we don't have to pay for them?
Roll a persuasion check. Same thing, you have
roll it twice.
Advantage. Yeah, roll it twice. 11 plus 6, so that's 17. Mm-hmm. She says, well, I can't give them to you for free. We're running a business, but I can give you a little bit of a deal.
Mm. I already drank mine. and I was never told that they cost anything. Well, I just asked for a mead and some hard liquor, and you gave it to me.
General
so
convention
it.
Of a business.
That's your fault for assuming that people know that.
He's from a town where you don't, because they did a deal with a demon, so nothing costs anything. That's why I was talking to you about that representative government.
We're tiefling. You recognize tiefling, don't you?
I recognize a tiefling.
All right.
So anyway,
you got to say that shit up front.
All right. Well, these two are free, but for the future, they're 50 cents. Silver pieces each.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you. Thank
you so much. Yeah. And you sure you don't know where Naya is?
Go ahead, because she got the friend spell, and you're all together. Roll persuasion on that.
Oh, no. What is persuasion?
Persuasion is wisdom.
Okay.
Charisma.
Oh, God. So I have a 7. I just rolled 7.
7?
No.
Roll again because we'll give you the advantage that his friend spell gave for this one.
So that's
one.
A 14.
14? She's kind of like smiles at you and says, well, you know, we're not allowed to divulge the name of any of our dancers, so.
She's a dancer here.
Well, I can't say any of the names of our dancers, but if there was a Naya, she might be in the back, but I'm not able.
He's looking for a lap dance.
Well, really?
Yeah,
all right.
You want some private time with Naya, if that's
well,
cool.
At noon, when the buffet starts, is also when the entertainment starts, so okay. At that point, the
I've
dances...
got a lot of gold for that. Yeah. Thaumaturgy. I pull out a pile of what looks like 500 gold pieces.
Ooh, well, you'll just need to give that to the dancer when they come out. And...
Yeah, I will do that. I seem to put it back in my pocket.
So you can't divulge the name of any dancers. Do they not tell us their names, or do they have different names than their real names?
Most people who dance in the Witch's Hut take on a stage name.
So what's Naya's stage name?
Oh, I couldn't tell you that.
Oh, convince her. She can be convinced. Convince her.
Look, listen. I know that you're just doing your job, and honestly, we're friends of our mother. Like, look, this is Naya's jewelry.
She left it.
Yeah, she left it. I'm just trying to get it back to her.
Oh.
You know, her mom's really worried about her, and I just want to make sure that she's okay, and I can give her some of her keepsakes.
Well, roll persuasion again on her, and again, you have advantage.
Come on.
It's a 19.
I mean... Yeah, you got a 19 plus 6, so yeah, you convince her. So she kind of says then, like, well, isn't that sweet? She kind of like looks over towards the buffet island where there's like another door that leads to a kitchen back there. And she kind of looks up and says, look, if you want to head in back and just be a couple minutes, you can bring that back to her and then come back out to get your lap dance, okay?
Thank you very much.
Appreciate that.
All right. Well.
You guys looking for any other dancers? You guys looking for dancers?
Oh, we're always looking.
I'm not a very modest tiefling.
Are you willing to? I see that. Would you be willing to join the coven?
I don't see any problem with it. I'd rather audition.
Oh, well, you'd have to audition for sure. It's just part of, if you were a dancer, you'd also have to join the coven as an acolyte before beginning work.
I masturbated in an office today.
Dear, you wouldn't have to do that for this job.
Just saying that I'm not.
We're a classy gentleman's club.
All right, I'm capable of anything this place needs if you guys are looking for, you know, dancers.
So how long till Naya gets out here?
Naya is, well, she'll, in the order, I believe she comes up second. Although if you want to, like I said, if you want to take your jewelry back and give it to her before she goes on stage, that's fine.
Let's do it.
What's her stage name?
Well, I'm sure you'll recognize her when you see her.
I mean, all is right. She going to be the only one back there?
All
right. All right, let's go.
Let's go back there.
Okay. So she kind of points you by the stage. There's like on one side of the stage, there's a door that leads to the backstage area without going like through the actual stage. And she waves you that way.
Before we leave, I put like a coaster on top of my mead. Even though it's an empty glass of mead, because I'm going to claim that it wasn't when I come back.
As we walk by, do we walk by the buffet table on the way back there?
No, it's on the other side of the.
All right.
I mean, you can go look at the buffet table if you want.
Yeah, I just wanted to snag something off the table as I walk back.
Okay.
I'm really itching to burn this woman's house down, so can we go back there and make sure that Naya's okay?
All right, so you go back to the backstage area, and it's kind of like a dark, and there's pretty clearly a dressing room a little ways down that hallway, and you can hear some voices in there. Otherwise, in this backstage area, there's like, it's kind of like a general like backstage. It's not particularly nice. Normally, customers don't come back here. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there's like mops in a corner and just general stuff. There's also a doorway that just has kind of an odd arcane looking symbol on it.
I grab a mop and hand it to Crash and say, hold this.
Why? Hold it. Why?
Just hold it.
But why?
Just hold it.
For what?
I got an idea.
All right. I hold them up.
I look at Craig and go, you're an idiot. And I start walking back to that room where we hear the voices coming from.
Let go of the mop, follow.
I really enjoyed that. All right, so you guys get back there. And yeah, it's a dressing room. And there's three younger women in there.
Is one of them obviously Naya?
So the image you saw of Naya... on the younger painting, when she was younger, it was, she was, sorry, I have that written down. She looked like a young woman, like 15-year-old, but the most distinguishing feature you saw was like just the most golden blonde hair. And these women, two of them have black hair, like jet black, and one of them has brown hair.
Hmm.
Hey, ladies. First off,
who are you?
What? I'm auditioning to be
new
a dancer.
Girl.
Yeah, I'm a new girl, not yet because they need to do some like background check stuff. We're looking for Naya. You seen Naya?
And they all kind of look at each other, and one of them says, "I'm Bambi, and we're not supposed to tell people our real names."
Oh yeah, but we're Naya's friends, so we're looking for Naya. I mean, we can tell you. If we weren't her friend, we would only know her stage name. So we know her real name because we're her friends.
One of them was like smoking. Well, when you guys came in, and she kind of says, "I mean, that does kind of make sense, Bambi."
So anyway, we're just dropping off her jewelry. She left it at home. We're just giving her jewelry back. It's.
And the third one kind of like actually perks up when you reveal that jewelry, and she like looks at the other two, and she doesn't say anything yet, but you notice, it's very obvious, she kind of glances the other two when she sees that jewelry.
Well, which color is the hair of that one?
It's jet black.
That's the jet black hair one?
Well, I use thaumaturgy to show them a picture of Naya with the three of us at what looks like a birthday party for her. See? We're her family.
The third one who kind of looked around said, like, I'm pretty sure that Naya would recognize you if she knew you and was here.
Unless... It's been a while. I usually wear clothes, and I only got a sheath today, so I don't know that Naya's ever seen me naked. It's a little off-putting. just want to say, like...
Bambi kind of says, like, you admit it's off-putting in your auditioning?
Yeah, we all end up naked on the floor, so why not just start there and see where it goes?
The idea of showing up naked was off-putting. I thought you were saying that you thought your own body was off-putting.
I grabbed the brown-haired girl.
Oh, my God.
Are you Naya?
Oh, my God.
So that was the one who was smoking when you came in?
God. Yeah.
How are you grabbing her? Are you, like, just grabbing her by the arms and shaking?
By her shoulders.
Okay, so roll a strength check.
Oh, God.
18, minus 1, 17.
17. So you grab her and you shake her, and she kind of like, the cigarette falls out of her mouth, and she like, her head goes, and Bambi kind of says like, oh my God, Crystal, what are you doing? And you, what were you saying to her?
I was saying, are you Naya? And then when I hear her, I think she's Bambi, this is Crystal, and I drop her and I grab the third girl. I go, you're Naya, I start screaming, you're Naya.
And Bambi goes like, that's destiny, that's destiny. And the one you're shaking, who's named Destiny, kind of says like, well, you're shaking, she does that thing of like, as you're shaking, if someone's shaking you, your voice kind of modulates with it, and she's like, okay, fine, I'm Naya. Right. Do you keep shaking her?
No, I stop shaking her and I put her down.
Okay, and the other two are kind of glaring at her after she said that. And she now says like, yeah, do you want? Who are you people?
We have your jewelry. How are you? Hey, it's been a while.
Hi.
I haven't seen you since your birthday. It was a while ago, but it was a birthday.
I'm
what
so...
What the fuck are you doing?
What are you talking about?
We know who she is now.
I know.
We don't need to continue that bullshit. Your mother hired us to come get you because she thinks you're bewitched and held here against your will.
Oh, my God. Really?
Yeah.
That's unbelievable.
That's terrible.
I'm not bewitched. I joined a coven.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I lost my daughter.
You shouldn't have said that.
I lost my real daughter.
She's going to burn your mom's house down.
I lost my real daughter, and your mom lied to my face about what it was like to lose. I'm going to kill your mom.
No, don't kill my mom.
Absolutely killing your mom.
Don't kill.
Wait a minute.
Please don't kill my mom.
Is it possible that you are bewitched right now, and that's why you're saying that?
I guess I wouldn't know if I was bewitched. She, like, looks a little puzzled now.
All right, so...
Can you come with us to wave at your mom through her window while her house is burning?
Please don't. I will try to stop you.
That's fine, but you can come with us and wave because I want her to see what it's like to have a daughter as she loses her own life.
What?
Because there's nothing that I wish I could give.
Oh, God.
I wish I could give my daughter's life.
All of the other girls like come up to you and like start pegging you and trying to hug you.
I would every day I wish I was dead and then she was alive.
I see her getting comforted, so then I start to make up a story that I also lost a child to get comfort as well.
Okay. So they're right now, they're coming up and like hugging you and like patting you on the back and be like, honey, it's okay.
No, I lost a pet wolf.
Oh my God.
It's just like the time when I lost.
Roll of persuasion check. Yeah.
A natural one!
So that's a natural one. Natural one, doesn't matter what the bonus is, that's an instant failure. You say that, and it's very clear from your demeanor that you're lying, and they all glare at you. Please, she lost her daughter. She lost her daughter.
Okay.
What are you doing?
You know what? I mean, some people don't like to put, like...
Unbelievable.
I mean, I get it. Yeah, I get it. Daughters are big, too, but y'all don't know how I felt about that, Wolf.
Shut up.
Whatever.
Shut up. You're unbelievable.
Okay. I want you to come with us, all three of you. to come with us while I burn this woman's house down.
What was our mission? Was our mission just to get this girl from the witches?
I don't know what our mission was. Our mission was about a kidnapping. This mm-hmm. girl's not kidnapped. She's a dancer. Yeah. And I don't judge.
So I'll tell you this. Well, so your characters in the past have done some sort of work for Tavlin. You definitely have. And so you know that the way the contracts that he has work, they're magical. So it's sort of like the payment is sealed into the scroll of the contract. So whatever the literal definition of completing the contract is, to get the payment from that is what you would have to do. And the literal payment was to save her from kidnapping. Now that's the official job. So you guys would know that about, your characters would know that about the job.
I would argue, based on our contract,
she has not been kidnapped.
That we have saved her from kidnapping, and when we return, we will definitely have the money. Mm-hmm. Because the kidnapping doesn't exist. And if these magical semantic contracts work based on words, and the kidnapping hasn't happened, therefore we have saved her from kidnapping.
Unless she's bewitched.
Well, then we'll all go to her mom's house, and we'll burn her house down.
So you guys are having this conversation in front of these dancers. Mm-hmm. And one of them, the one named Bambi, who's a bit older than the others, mm-hmm. but like bit aloof, but she's drop dead gorgeous. Mm-hmm. And she kind of like is listening to you, and she seems to be almost in charge of them, and kind of says to you guys as you're talking about this, like, why do you think someone would be bewitched here? Of course no one's bewitched.
It's called witches.
Why are you saying that suddenly? Why are you saying that suddenly and so defensively?
I'm curious why you are so worried. Would someone, are you implying that someone wouldn't choose this life?
Yeah, that's yes. what your mom's implying. Her mom's implying that nobody would choose to be a dancer. I find that offensive.
I find it offensive too.
Do you know that she made equivalent a daughter choosing to do with whatever her body is, she wants to do with the death of, she made those equivalent to, and she looked at me.
It's okay, it's okay.
She looked at me and said that my daughter dancing is equivalent to your daughter being dead.
That is awful.
She burned.
Terrible.
As she's being moved by this, I come in real quick and go, did you put a spell on her?
She's startled by that and kind of pushes you away. It says, no, I wouldn't put a spell on her. Why'd you do that?
All right.
Were you trying to throw me off?
I asked a direct question. You gave me an answer.
How about this? Since we are just trying to make money, all of us here are trying to make money, just trying to get by. You know, this town, the representative government, there are no witches, there are no tieflings. There's a lot of shitty stuff happening in this town. Why don't you guys come with us back to this temp agency? We'll all be there. If she's been kidnapped, then we'll know at that moment that she's been kidnapped, and any reluctance on your part to go to that temp agency will also imply to us that she's been kidnapped. But if we go and she hasn't been kidnapped, we get paid, and we'll make you a fourth partner.
Look, I don't know where you're coming in with all this stuff. I don't know what job you're talking about.
We have a job to make sure she's not kidnapped.
I use my friend spell.
Okay.
And it's like, look, just do us a favor. If all three of you guys just come with us.
All three of them.
All three of you come with us. It's going to be a real fun time. We're a real fun group. And then at the end of the day, we get paid. And I get to buy some nice jewelry that I'm buying. And then, I don't know, maybe we'll take you out for drinks later or something. Yeah. It's a good time.
Yeah.
Roll a persuasion check and you have advantage on it again. And roll it again. Use the higher number.
Come on, 20.
2 12s. All right. So that's 18. So Bambi is kind of like weighing it back and forth. And she says like, well, listen, honestly, I could possibly be convinced by that because you are a smooth talker, sir. Mm. But I don't think the rest of the coven will like it. And frankly, Destiny has a shift to go on today, so I don't feel like we can leave.
What does the history thing mean here on my abilities?
History is a type of check. If it has to do with like the history of something. Has not come up yet today.
Okay.
Okay, then how about this? How about one of you, not you, Bambi, you should come with us, but you and Destiny come with us because Destiny's the most important, and the other one can stay here and cover for her shift.
There you go. I'll throw in all the gold I have on me.
And Destiny, Naya, is kind of like, I don't see why this is a problem. It should be fine.
Right.
Can't we just go? I'll go, yes, I'll go and tell my mom for the umpteenth time that this is my life and she has to deal with it.
Oh my God, and you can look at her while I burn her.
Please don't burn my mom.
I mean, she said that you only went back one time. Like, you've only visited her once since you up and left? That seems kind of...
Well, yeah, but that was like a week ago.
You were just there. Oh my God! This lady.
I thought it was
this lady.
What did she say?
This lady.
She said it was at least like what, like 4 or 5 weeks or something. She hadn't seen you.
No.
That's what she said. Wait.
Really? I trust her over the lying old mom.
I mean, I don't know, cause you seem a little out of it. Like, do y'all do like drugs here or something, or just like, or maybe you could be bewitched. Come with us. We'll find out if you come with us.
Okay. Yeah, I should just come with.
Great. Let's get out of here.
I'll come with.
Great. We're going to stop by your mom's house on the
it's
way home,
fine.
On the way back.
I'll be back in time. She's like talking to Bambi now. Mm. I'll be back in time. Bambi's kind of looking at you guys and like thin line mouth and is just kind of saying like, all right.
Great. Mm-hmm. So we leave?
So you want to leave out the
front? Yeah, let's leave with her. Yeah.
All right. So you guys walk out the front.
Great.
I take one of those meat on a stick things from the buffet without
mutton,
paying.
Mutton thing.
And walk out.
Well, I'll tell you. So before you get out, you go through the hallway and you get out the front. And there's a few more people there now. There's like some elf businessmen types at the lunch buffet. Mm-hmm. They're sitting there waiting for the show to start. And you're coming out with Destiny, with Naya, and...
I pause at the bar and say, hey, who drank my beer?
So the motherly woman behind the bar, first she addresses you and says, like, sir, I saw you put that over an empty glass. I was right here.
Wow. This is... I can't believe what I'm hearing.
Well, okay, but... And then she turns to Naya and kind of says, like, dear, where are you going?
We are heading over to where our temp agency is so that she can sign off on this contract so we get paid. She's coming right back. We don't judge anything that happens here.
And she kind of like looks at you and is like, well, I don't mean to be a bother, but I'm pretty sure, Destiny, that you are supposed to go up soon.
Yeah, it's right.
And we have a lot of paying customers who are here.
Super fast. It's a real quick trip. And what's more, I don't know how your business works, but I promise to lobby for witches in government so that you guys can get some kind of better zoning, because this is a terrible area.
Well, okay, that doesn't help in the moment. And as she's like talking to you, like kind of like seems like she's trying to convince Destiny to stay and do her set, there's another woman like who seems to be coming out and stalking the island buffet, and it is just the oldest crone of a woman you've ever seen. She's like hunchback, has a bit of a hump here, big nose, like wart on it, and like scraggly straw like hair. And she like is bringing out some more mutton chops for the buffet and looks over and kind of goes, what's she doing out of the back room? Destiny, get back there.
All right, I use thaumaturgy to throw a voice to the back room that's of someone screaming for help. So it sounds like one of the witches back there is screaming for help from the back.
One of the witches? Okay. Sorry, I'm just looking for one thing. Why can't I find this? Sorry, guys. I lost something on here. Okay. So that happens. They have to. You're fine. You can do it for free, but they have to roll to see if they are fooled by it. So they are not. And the old one says, "Like, oh, you're trying to play magic tricks with me, huh?"
Now this is I can do this as much as I want, right?
I mean, you can do it as much as you want, but once they are convinced, like you can keep doing it, but they're not going to be on further attempts. But yes, if you wanted, you could just make that screaming go on like every time you want.
But if I can't convince her, I'm not going to keep doing it.
That's what I thought. So the old one kind of turns to the one at the bar and says, like, Astrid, are you okaying this? And one at the bar says, Madam Yaza, they were just going back so that she could do her set. It'll be fine.
Can I explain something to you, old lady?
Mm-hmm.
First off, we are not trying to cause trouble. We have a contract. All we have to do is show them that she's not kidnapped and we get paid. That's it. We're just walking across town so that we get paid. We are not kidnapping your dancer. I'm auditioning later. I need a job. I'm not even going to try and persuade you because that's all the truth.
So she kind of like stares at you and hold on one sec. So she kind of stares at you directly and like is like staring deep in your eyes. Mm. Roll a wisdom check.
Oh no. Okay, I've got a 14 minus 1, so 13.
13? Okay. You kind of like feel fuzzy for a sec and you can hear her almost in your head going like, "Wouldn't you like to audition now?"
I would.
So you are not charmed, but you're just saying that apropos of like, of your own free will.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I, wildly thinking I'm helping, hit the old witch in the back of the head with my mace?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, you can do that if you want.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, so well, she's like dead, staring, locked eyes with Cratch. Okay, roll your attack.
Wait, which one is that?
Roll your d20.
Since this is going to be a surprise attack, I would like to continue speaking to the witch while he's swinging.
Sure. And,
and while this is going on, can I just be trying to leave with Naya?
Sure. So she's like, seems a little transfixed by everything going on, like watching this crossing of witches as they talking to Cratch. So let's do this in order. So first, you're attacking the witch in the back of the head.
Mm-hmm.
You're trying to pull Naya out. She's like almost like she's rooted to the spot.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So you can try pulling her, but you'll have to roll for it.
What is that?
Fight music.
Mm-hmm. We're not fighting, I'm auditioning.
He's
right.
Roll your attack.
All right.
10. And because it's distracting while she's trying to charm Cratch, you'll have advantage. So roll it again and use the higher. 16. Okay. So that's an 18. You clock the old witch Yaza in the back of the head.
What?
So you hit her in the back of the head. Roll your damage, which is going to be 1d6. So that's the cube.
Does her getting hit in any way affect Naya's being glued to the floor?
Roll to pull her. So just do a strength check.
Oh.
I assume I fall. I try and pull her and I fall down.
That is what happens. You're doing this, and she is like rooted, to be fair. But yeah, you do that thing where you're pulling so hard, your feet kind of slip a little, because it's a shitty bar, so like the ground's a little sticky, and you just kind of like stumble and fall. Well, you're clocking the old witch in the back of the head. How much damage do you do?
Oh,
okay, one damage. Sorry, I'm just finding my little sheet for her. You don't have to look at all this stuff. All right, so she gets hit in the back of the head with a mace. And she kind of screeches that like old lady like, "Ah, no! What? Treachery, sisters!" And there's like some smoke, and so she got hit in the back of the head with a mace. All of a sudden, the one behind the bar like perks up and that smile just disappears. And there's like some smoke, and then the very young looking one from the back, the dancer who seemed to be in charge of the other ones, Bambi, she appears. Mm. And so now you guys are kind of caught, you're on the floor. You were just saying you wanted to audition and you hit one in the back of the head. So I guess you're behind the old one, but you guys are like caught in the middle of a triangle of the old witch, the middle-aged witch, and the young witch. And they are all started weave spells.
Ah, oh, great.
So they're attacking you now. And the other patrons seem to think this is part of a show.
Great.
Like those business elves are like starting to hoot and cheer.
I'm going to own this property by the end of the day.
Now, because we'll call that attack is going first. So now we're in a fight, so it'll go a little more like turn by turn. Heather, you'll go next.
God. First, I swear at him. As I begin to rage, I yell, consider this my audition.
Great.
And I would like to try and two-handed battle axe the main old woman.
The old lady?
Just square in the chest.
Great. So she just got hit, so yeah, she's like pretty out of it. So
and
yeah,
I would assume getting hit in the back of the head means she's stumbling towards me.
Yeah, you don't have to move.
So I'm gonna swing home run style.
Great.
Into her chest.
Great, roll your d20.
Great. Ugh, 5 plus, how do I do this?
After your battle axe, it'll say on, or to hit. And it'll say plus something.
It's plus 5 to hit, so that's a 10.
10?
Yeah.
No, it's you rear back and you swing so hard that you go right over her old lady
God
head.
Damn it.
So Miles.
Wait.
Oh, with Ray, no.
And I have advantage on strength checks and strength saving throws.
That's an attack though. It's not a saving throw or a.
It's not
check.
A strength check.
It's not a check. It's an attack. So.
All right.
Sorry. Miles, Jimmy, it's your turn.
All right, I'm on the floor, right? So yeah. I stay down there just because I figure okay. I'm safer down low. Okay. And I start trying to crawl out. I'm trying to get out of here.
God damn it.
Okay.
I'm already down. It seems that the trouble seems to be happening at their level.
Uh-huh.
So I don't do anything. I just try and crawl to the exit.
Roll stealth check.
A one.
So we'll say. So you are trying to crawl out. And you're assuming just forgetting not. Yeah, you're just trying to leave.
Yeah.
So you are crawling out and roll the 2d10s. So we'll say this is out of 100.
42.
Okay. So you, as you're crawling, you are like trying, there's like some bar stools because you were pretty close to the bar. And you kind of like, while you're looking back to see if anybody's watching you, run into one and knock over a bar stool that like dominoes the other bar stools. So there's just a bunch of clattering. Everybody sees you.
So the entire place looks at me.
And that's your turn.
But now I'm distracted.
Yeah. Your turn.
So then, while Jimmy distracts them, I guess we gotta get out of here. So I guess I wanna use my magic missile.
Uh-huh. And who are you using it on?
Well, it's 3 glowing balls, right? And there's 3 of them, right?
Yeah, you could send 1 to each.
Yeah, let me do that.
Okay, great.
Wait. Are all 3 of them aggressive towards us?
Yeah, it's like the 3, so the old one, the middle-aged one, and the young one who show up and kind of make a triangle around you, they seem to all
so many
be
ones.
Like connected in some way, you can tell. You would assume, I think all of you would kind of know this in general, about which is that this is probably a coven, the main coven. Mm-hmm. And so they're all like weaving spells at you. So yeah, they're all seem
okay.
aggressive.
So then, yeah, let me go... throw 1 at each one.
Okay.
And as I'm releasing it, I say, Bambi, we could have been something. And then I throw the ball.
Okay. So you don't even have to roll for magic missile. That's why it's great. You're just going to, or you they definitely hit. You're going to, each one will do 1d4.
Each of this one?
Yeah. So go ahead and check that.
Roll it?
Yeah. So we'll say the first one's for the old one, 3 damage. who you already hit for one. Mm-hmm. So, okay. And the next one. 4. Great. That was for the middle-aged one. And for Bambi, the young one. 4. Great. So you are hurting all these witches. great. So they each get hit in the face with a glowing missile. However, now you are actually, you're a sorcerer. You're a wild sorcerer, mm-hmm. where your character is. So I don't know if you saw this on your character sheet. Every time you cast a spell, there's going to be a possible wild magic surge. Mm-hmm. So all that means is you're going to roll a d20 now. If you roll 1, something very bad might happen.
To them or me?
It's random.
Ooh, 20!
Ooh, nothing bad happens. You know what? I'll say this, because it's a natural 20, roll, and the random thing only happens if it's a good thing for you.
Oh.
All right? So roll the 2 d10s.
Oh, these two?
Actually, that one and this one.
This one and this one?
Kind of what Miles just did, and then just tell me. So that would be a 11. I'll say this is not. Yeah, it's not. I'll say this. It's not good, but it's not like gonna hurt you, so I'll give you the choice if it happens or not. You develop an allergy to all magical items. You cannot control sneezing until all magical items are removed. Last 1d6 turns.
Why would you want that?
Yeah, so I'd say no, it doesn't happen.
Yeah. You said it was only the good thing.
Yeah.
Good
well, thing. I was saying, like, I'm not going to force it. If was a 1, that would have happened no matter what.
All right.
But it wasn't, like, damage, so I was like, I'll give you the choice. Okay, so that's your turn. You did that damage. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Now it's the witch's turn. And before you go, I'll say Naya is, like, looking around a little bit and, like, seems a little dazed, and she kind of, like, runs behind the bar to hide. Mm-hmm. So now the old witch is kind of like, who's getting batted around, turns around and glares at you because you clocked her. And she kind of waves a hand and sends a blast of energy at you.
Oh, shit.
Where did I put that? There it is. Okay, yeah, that's gonna hit. She sends a blast at you and does 5 damage.
Oh no.
So you're down to 5 hit points.
Yeah.
The next one, the middle-aged one, casts a spell. Not at you guys, but towards the elvish businessmen.
Oh,
and they kind of get that same, like, staring deep into their eyes look she has, but towards them. And there's 3 of them. Okay, so 2 of them just kind of, like, look a little, like, they stop hooting, and they kind of, like, look confused. But then one of them gets glassy-eyed and just starts running towards you guys with fists up. And then the young one, Bambi, attacks.
Wait a minute, one guy can't run toward all 3 of us. We're in different parts of the room.
He runs towards the general melee.
Okay.
They're by the stage, so they're far enough away, so you don't know which specific one. Sorry, I wasn't clear about mm-hmm. that. And then Bambi tries to send a blast of energy at you, but misses.
Good.
Goes right over your head. Back to you.
I'm gonna, swing to, I would like specifically to try and split the head of the old witch with my battle axe.
Okay, great. Roll your
d20. Great. Come on, 20. Ugh, 4.
4 plus 5. That misses again.
God,
so far you've gone right over this old lady and right to the left.
Great.
Ugh. Miles.
All right, now if I use thaumaturgy, is that my turn?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So then I wouldn't be able to attack if I chose to attack.
Yeah. You have one, and also because this is a new fight, you have 1 spell slot for your level 1 spells, the red ones.
Mm-hmm.
You could use command, you could use hex, you've got a crossbow.
Let's try.
If you just want to use a spell that you can use as much as you want, Eldritch Blast is a good, like, long distance spell.
Right. Yeah, I'll go ahead and try Eldritch Blast since I haven't tried it yet, so I'm going to use that. Hey, can we ask, like, how many hit points the old lady has left?
I'm not going to tell you specifically, but I can tell you, like, how they look. Like, if they look like, oh, beat to hell.
How's she looking?
Yeah. The old lady? She's not, like, bleeding, but she looks a little, like, flustered and knocked around.
All right, so she's only halfway down. So I'm going to guess she's got a bunch of health left. Eldritch Blast on the old lady.
Okay. Roll your d20, and you're going to add
and again,
your spell.
I'm still on the floor, and I'm over by the bar, and now I'm sort of doing this from behind some the stools that I knocked over. It's like sort of, it's very cowardly looking.
Yeah. And whatever you roll, add 5 to it.
19.
Oh, yeah, you blast her. And it says damage at the bottom of Eldritch Blast.
1d10.
Oh, so roll your d10.
1d10.
Just one of them.
Just the 60 or the...
It doesn't matter which one. If it's the 60, just pretend it's single digit.
7.
7? So you do 7 damage to her. So you hit that old lady square in the face with a blast of energy.
If I don't take her out, she's gonna have a little bit more.
And she again does that kind of like, ah! Old woman scream. Guap. I keep forgetting your name and having to look again. Guaplar.
3,000. I'm mad at that old woman because mm-hmm. she clocked me. Mm-hmm. So I take my mace and with all the power of anger within me, I come with in like an uppercut blow, like I'm trying to take her head off of her shoulder.
Uh-huh. Great. So roll your d20.
Please don't one.
And you're gonna
please
add...
don't one. Not bad thing.
Okay, yeah, you hit her. So roll 1d4. Or no, sorry.
You have so much magic. Sorcerer hit her with a mace.
Roll your 1d6.
It was going to have
the cube. I love the idea. You have all this magic and you're just like.
He's hitting her with a mace.
It's kind of, that's pretty brutal. You're a sick fuck.
Hey! Oh,
all right, so you clock her, and she's hanging on by a thread. Like, you uppercut her with this mace, and her old neck goes back. You think you almost hear a crack. Like, she is looking terrible now. She's got blood dribbling down her warted old nose. Great. And she looks somehow even worse than you first saw her. This hag is not looking great.
Great.
And now, it's her turn.
Great.
But she is weak, though, so...
She's not looking good. And you did just uppercut her with a mace, so she looks straight at you and just glares at you. And she starts muttering under her breath.
Uh-oh.
And go ahead.
You're gonna die.
So, roll a wisdom saving throw.
Wait, which one?
So you're gonna roll your d20 and add your wisdom modifier to it.
Come on.
She's like staring straight at you and muttering.
Okay.
And you feel like something constricting you. Right. Six. But you are able to bust free.
Yay!
And it was like, you could tell like she was trying to hold you in one spot so you couldn't move or do anything.
Oh,
but you were able to bust free. She wasn't able to do it.
Got it.
So she's even more upset that you broke her spell, because it's a little bit of an affront to a witch, I would say, that she can't hold a simple human sorcerer. The middle-aged one can't see you, by the way, because she's behind the bar casting spells, and you're like right in front of her. So she's just focusing on the other people. So you are literally hiding from her, basically.
Yes.
I guess she heard the stools fall, but she's not focusing on you. So she casts a spell at Cratch.
Oh my god.
And she casts just another blast of energy. Natural 20.
All right, let's see what it is.
So she does.
Scratch dice. Two whiffs and death.
7 damage.
Oh, that's okay. Right.
Yeah, how much you got? You got 15
hit
points. You're
right.
Doing fine. And then, however, the businessman elf that she like charmed before runs up to you too.
Bring
and
it.
This like is kind of like a scrawny. It looks like he's like a little pudgy. He's not a fighter, but he's like runs up to you and says, "For madam!" Mm-hmm. And he like just tries to thwap you with his fist.
Okay.
Yeah, does not hit you.
Great.
You feel like his fist does go, but it's like a mm-hmm. on your back. And then the Bambi, the young witch, sees you trying to hide, tries to send a blast of energy at you. And it hits those chairs that you're hiding behind. So now it's your turn.
Hey, I'm gonna try and split the businessman in half.
Great.
Okay, 4.
Add your bonus.
What is it, strength?
It's plus 5, I believe.
Plus
so 9,
yeah.
It hits him.
Good.
So roll your damage.
What is that? So I'm a plus 2 damage.
Uh-huh.
Plus, wait. Plus
6. Your
1d10 plus 3 plus yes. 2. So what is that? This one?
D10 is, no, it's the, the one that with the double digits on.
Yeah, that's,
yeah. Okay. Oh, sorry, I thought you were picking up a different
one. So this, okay, is a 10 plus 3. So
that's a
1. 3, 2.
So how do you hit this guy?
So I hit, how do I hit him?
Describe how you're swinging. Like
I'm swinging, because I was just low, because I missed on that mm-hmm. cleave.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to split him laterally from his groin.
So, in something that this guy, as he went on his lunch break to a strip club, probably was almost the opposite of what he was expecting, that axe catches his groin, and starting there, just opens him like a butchered cow up here, and goes like, if you imagine going up here, and as this thing goes, it's not cleaving him in half, but it's close enough that as soon as the blade passes and trails and stuff are coming up, and goes here, and then like that, and it's like everything inside of him spills out in front of you.
Good.
And he's dead.
Good.
In case that wasn't clear from my description, he dies.
Good.
So you murdered him.
No, I defended myself.
And his business elf buddies in the back, they were like hooting things and stuff, and they all shut up. They're like, you kind of can just hear one say, "Jerry." So now it's Miles' turn.
Well, one, I look at her and I shake my head. But then I turn back to the old woman who's hanging on by a thread, and I hit her with another Eldritch Blast.
Great. Roll your d20.
3.
Ugh. Yeah,
attack bonus plus 5.
It goes over her head.
You want the attack bonus plus 5, spell attack bonus plus 5?
Yeah, yeah, right. It doesn't hit her. Your turn, Ronnie.
She's hanging on by a thread, huh?
You better cast a fucking spell. You get a plus 6 spell attack bonus. All right.
I hit her with the shock or the frost. I'm going to hit her with the ray of frost.
Great. So roll your d20 and add 6 to whatever you roll.
15.
21.
Yeah, that's gonna hit her. So roll, you know what, it doesn't even matter. If you rolled a 1, it would still kill her.
I just missed her.
So you, and you're point blank. So imagine your ray of frost is this far away. You hold out her hand and just ice flows from your hand into her face and you make an icicle of this old woman.
Great.
And she just pauses and like shatters.
Right.
So the old one is dead.
Woo!
Can she be frozen, and as I look at her frozen thing, take my dagger and stab the ice and then it shatters?
Sure.
Thank you.
Sure. That's what you do. Great. So she's dead. You kind of, and the other two, both almost simultaneously, both, Yaza, no! You assume that's her name.
Mm-hmm.
So the other two, like, both turn to you.
Neither do I have.
And they both start casting spells at you. Middle-aged one first sends an energy, and she's distraught.
Botch.
So you almost feel like her aim's worse. Like she's just like not even thinking about it, not concentrating. And so she. Okay, so she does still hit, even though she's distracted and with her rage. So she does. One damage.
Oh, okay.
The other one is also just as distraught, and they're like almost crying while they do, because you assume there's some sort of bond between these three riches. Other one also hits. They have disadvantage too. They're rolling twice and taking the lower number. Uh-huh. It's rolling well. Also one. Oh. You got very lucky. Okay, so now it's back to Cratch.
All right, who's nearest me of the two witches?
The closest is Bambi. You'd have to like run over, but it's close enough that you could like run over to her and still attack.
Great, I would like to run and swing at her arm. Mm-hmm. Wait, do they have to like do this to cast, or is it with their heads?
Every time they've been doing that, they've been muttering, but they have also, for some of the spells, you've seen them doing small head motions.
I'll just go for her chest. Mm-hmm. Just one. Try and take my axe, my fancy axe, and bury it.
Your brand new axe. And
bury it in her chest.
Great.
Right? Please 20. Ugh, 3.
Oh my god. I feel bad for you. You're rolling so badly.
Whiff.
It is funny to imagine how often, other than the one not fighter that you've cleaved into, you've whiffed on the witches every time. That's amazing. Miles, your turn.
All right. I'm going to stand up and turn to the witch behind the bar.
Okay.
Right? And command mead.
So you can use one of your level one spells in that. I love it. All right. So go ahead and do that. So she has to roll to see if she obeys you. Great. And she fails. So from her perspective, she's like focusing, and she's still upset. Her sister just died. She's like just cast a spell here. Then right in front of her, you pop up, and in like a magically infused voice, just go,
mead.
And she like snaps out of her distraught nature and just says, nods and like turns, takes the cup that was empty and takes the coaster off and goes to refill your mead. And we'll say the next time she has a turn, she can't attack because she's filling your mead.
Right.
Your turn, Ron.
All right. So I look over at Jimmy like, for real? Then she can't attack next one around there. Then I use my Ray of Frost on Bambi. Should I use the shotgun grass? Now I'm gonna use the Ray of Frost again. Ray of Frost on Bambi.
Okay, so roll your d20. Plus 6 to whatever you roll. Ooh, I can't see.
8.
8, 14, that hits.
Yay!
Roll your d8.
Which one is that?
That's the diamond one.
All right, this one. All right.
Seven. So you hit her with the frost, and she's also like, seems like she's moving a little slower. Mm. Like, it's not gonna make a big deal because she's not like running away from you guys, but if she was, she would like be slowed down too. Mm. Great. So Astrid is busy pouring you mead, so that's all she does with her turn. Mm. Bambi is still upset with you because she hasn't been hit by anything else yet. But she just got. She may have focused on you, but you whiffed so badly that she's still gonna attack you. And sends a blast of energy, and it goes right past you.
Woo!
Oh,
so now it's Cratch's turn.
Okay.
Cratch, do your solid.
Cratch is gonna swing at Bambi as hard as possible. I'm gonna aim for her neck.
Okay.
I'm gonna try and behead her. Possible. Let's see, that is a 6 plus, what is it, 5?
5.
11?
Nope.
Unbelievable.
This is
Jesus
real bad.
Christ.
Back to Miles.
All right, so have I gotten my mead yet?
We'll say, yeah, at the end of, like, over her turn is spent finishing pouring the mead and bringing it and setting it down to you. And very, like, she can't do anything, but the last thing she does in her turn. And also, so you guys know, in case anybody at home doesn't know, these rounds, like, every time everybody, that's, like, the span of, like, 6 seconds. So this is how fast this is all happening. She brings it over and kind of, like, blinks confusedly. So now it's your turn. You have this mead in front of you. She's, like, confused.
All right, well, I'm gonna hit her right in the face with the Eldritch Blast.
Great.
Now that I got my mead, and I want to be drinking it while I just sort of cast it right into her face.
Love it. Go for it.
Please hit.
18.
Oh. 18.
Plus 5 is my spell attack.
Yeah,
bonus.
You hit her.
23.
Roll your D10.
A D10. One of the D10s, right?
Come on.
Yeah.
6.
66.
6. Great. So she's looking confused. You're drinking and do that, and it's so close. Her head, like, it doesn't snap her neck, but like it knocks her back. And actually, I'll say it does an extra point of damage because it's so point blank. And she's so unprepared for it. So like she's not dead, but she's not looking great.
And of course, I then just lower myself back down. To sit on the behind the thing.
The most baffling thing to happen to a witch ever. Ronnie, your turn.
The one at the bar. Mm-hmm. Let me hit her with that shocking grasp.
So shocking grasp, you have to actually be able to touch her. So, you're close enough. This is not a huge room, so you're close enough. You could run over and just grab her and do this. Mm-hmm. But yeah, you want to use shocking grasp.
Yeah, let me shocking grasp her.
So you run up, just reaching for her. Mm-hmm. And for shocking grasp, you're gonna roll an attack to roll against her.
Well, which one is this?
D20.
Oh, okay. 19.
Oh, man, the difference between your two rolls is insane.
Stop it.
So you hit, roll 1d8, and you do that much lightning damage to her. So like it's crackling.
Cratch had a bad day. She did spent a lot of time remembering her dead daughter.
Yeah, D8.
This mission this threw her off.
Emotionally and physically hard.
A 4.
4? All right, great. And that means she, you like do that, and she just like shakes from it and just slumps down. She's out.
Okay.
Is she dead or is she just unconscious?
Are you trying to kill her or are you just trying to knock her out?
I mean,
it's like right on the edge, so I'll let you decide.
I mean, I at this point, I am very mad. Like, mm-hmm. You're asking me right now as a level-headed person, but in that fight, I'm so mad that I probably am trying to kill her, because she's trying to kill me.
Yeah, she's dead.
Yeah.
You killed her with electricity.
I'll take out 2 witches, guys. Somebody take out a witch.
And real fast, I'm getting a question from the chat room from our producers. That sounded way too official. We've got one guy in the chat room. Our producer, Will. Apparently someone doesn't know what cantrips are. Cantrips are basically very simple spells that the spellcasters, it's so easy to cast for them. There's no limit on how many times per day they can do it. Like, hence why Miles has used thaumaturgy about 15 times this show. But yeah, that's a cantrip. That's all that means. Level 1 spells then, they have only a set number of times they can cast it between rests, or in the case of this, in one day. I think that's enough of an explanation. Back to the fight! So, you just did that. You killed that witch. The only one left is Bambi, and she's, like, just furious now. And she's, like, almost glowing. She's so angry that you've decimated her coven. And she's right next to you.
Great.
So now she just comes after you.
Great.
And she reaches out, similar to what he just did, and tries to grab, like, basically, like, as if she's boxing your ears. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're not wearing any armor, right?
No, I'm not wearing anything.
Great, so that helps you. Oof, she hits you.
That's fine.
And does 7 damage.
Oh my God.
What are you at?
1.
So it's your turn now.
Well.
She just grabbed your head and sent electricity pulsing through your brain.
Jesus Christ, lady. I haven't hit anybody. I'm gonna try. So she's here?
Yeah.
I'm gonna try and cut her in half midway.
Well, let's see if you can do it.
That would be better.
10 plus 5, right?
You hit her!
Yes! Yes! Now, strength tech, right? Strength?
Nope, you roll your damage.
So it's D10 plus 3 plus 2.
Yes, so D10 plus 5.
Okay. So that's a 9. So 14?
14. So this one, she's angry. So imagine she's grasping your head and just shot you and just glaring at you. She hates you guys so much. You killed his sisters, and you, having whiffed so much in this fight, these witches are not worried about you, about Cratch at all. It looks like just a lumbering barbarian. You're a half-orc, right? Or no, a tiefling. You're a lumbering tiefling running around. No worry at all. And then while she's grabbing you, you do this, and your ass goes clean through her midsection. And she like almost does, it's like that like tablecloth trick where she almost doesn't realize it at first. And then her eyes go wide, and like, almost like in a samurai movie, it
slides off.
Great.
And you have killed all these witches.
Great.
You froze one and stabbed it, shattered it with a dagger, electrocuted one to death, and cleaved one in two. The businessmen, oh, and killed a business elf. The business elves in the back are throwing up. And like, they're just crying. Naya was behind the bar, and she kind of peeks her head up and says like, oh my God.
Can I approach a businessman?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I'm gonna be like, are you with this guy that attacked me? Were you with him?
I don't know why he did.
Because are you gonna? Because
we all felt something in our head when that witch looked at us, but we didn't do it. We didn't do anything. Jerry's crazy. That guy's a nut.
I use thaumaturgy, and I make the businessmen think that each one thinks the other one is a sexy stripper.
So you're making the illusion be that they all look like sexy strippers.
Yeah, they each think the other one is a sexy stripper. Yeah.
There's two of them.
There's two of them.
Yeah, so each one. So to your guys' perspective, because they can't see themselves, right. To your perspective, they both look like sexy strippers.
No, to our perspective, they just look like two businessmen, but to their perspective.
I see what you're saying.
Can I do that?
Usually an illusion is not like that specific to each person, but like it'll be the same effect if to you guys, to just everybody they look at, but they are just looking at the other one, right?
Yeah.
Great. So they look at it, let's see if they're fooled. One of them is fooled and one of them is too distraught to be fooled. So one like does a double take and like, he's like crying and he's, but he like still is a little bit of a horn dog. So he's like eyeing what he thinks of the woman. So it's like, now that like the fighting seems to be done, he's like getting up his courage and says like, hey, man, we should go. I can get you to safety. And his friend looks at him like, what the fuck? Terry, what are you doing?
Great.
And he's confused by that, but he sees a sexy stripper and his life is like turned upside down of this. So he kind of tries to hustle her off. Are you guys still talking to them or are you just going to let them go?
Is this a multiple story building?
No.
It's just one floor?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to go in the back and look for an office.
Okay. When you get them back, so you're letting those business elves go.
Yeah, yeah.
So you go back and in that little hallway you were before where you heard the voices before, there was that dressing room. And then the other side I had mentioned there was a door with like a arcane symbol on it. Mm-hmm. That's the only other door you see.
Hey guys. Hey, come check out this door.
I get up from in front of the bar, and I finish my beer, and I put it on the bar, or my mead, and I go back to check out the door.
Uh-huh. And I still mad, go to the register and open it and take all the money out.
How much money is in the register?
There is. It's the beginning of the day, so it's not as much as you might expect, but you guys didn't pay for your drinks. So because the only customers so far were those three businessmen,
the drunk elf that was there already when we got there.
Oh yeah, he didn't wake up through all this. The drunk elf, and like as you're opening the register, through all that he was down, and you see his head just kind of like turn a little, like, that's shit, another one. And he goes back down. But you find 15 gold in there.
Okay,
that's not bad.
Take that.
So you find that door, you call that. Are you going back there?
Yeah, I went back there.
Great. So you guys are standing in front of this door.
Hey guys, I feel like shit. I have had a rough time of it. I'm worried that if I try and open this door, it's gonna like zap me and I'll just drop dead.
So also, if you guys wanna wait a few minutes, you can basically, the hit dice thing on your sheets, you can regain some hit points if you want now that you're out of the fight.
Oh, great.
You can only do that once per day.
I'll do that right now.
So if you, what does yours say, 1D?
I don't know where I'm looking.
The wide box in the middle of the sheet, lower left.
Hit dice, 1d12?
Yeah, so roll a d12. Whatever you roll, you get that many hit points
is that
back.
This one, yeah?
Yes.
Great.
Plus whatever the plus next to your constitution is.
Okay.
So 5 plus 3.
So you get 8 back.
So I have 9 now. Great.
Does anybody else want to use their hit die to heal? You're fine, right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I didn't lose anything.
I did too. 1d6.
So if you want to heal, yeah, you can do the same thing. So roll the cube.
Right.
And then add your constitution's +3. So +3 to whatever you roll. 5. So you get 5 more. Great. So you two are at that door. You're emptying the cash register.
I'm gonna axe the door.
I hold it, and I use some thaumaturgy to try and open the door.
It opens.
Dumbass.
All right, what's in? Can I look in the room?
So as you look in, you see it looks on a first glance like you see a desk. You see it looks like an office.
Mm-hmm.
But then as you look, it's like, oh, there's also a cauldron in one corner that seems to be boiling with things. Mm-hmm. There's a bunch of potions on one wall.
Great. Can I go through the desk?
Sure.
Or a file cabinet?
Sure. Roll a investigate check.
Oh, man.
And tell me what you're looking for.
What is it? I'm looking for a deed.
A deed?
Yeah.
Okay.
To the building. Where's the...
D20.
D20.
And okay. Then add your intelligence.
Oh, boy. 20!
Natural 20?
Yeah.
So but you're looking through...
+0.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So you... and if it's a natural 20 on the die, you succeed no matter what. So Cratch, to shit Cratch, is in these witches next to this witch's desk, rummaging through papers. Were you coming in also?
Yeah.
Okay. So you see Cratch rummaging through papers, the one who was just going to axe the door down. And she's rummaging, and all of a sudden, Cratch stops and just, like, stands bolt upright and holds up a paper. And it's the deed. You found the deed. It wasn't in a locked file or anything. In, like, the back of the file was the deed to the witch's hut.
Okay. I'm going to sign the deed to myself.
Okay. You would need a notary public for that.
Okay, so wait. Wait, what does that mean?
You would probably, to sign a deed over to you, hypothetically, I think you would need the witches, like one of the witches to be in front of a notary public to sign it over to you.
Great. I've got a great plan, guys. I've got a great plan.
And what are you guys doing now?
We had, let's get this girl back to the office so we can get paid.
No. Let's get the girl to the notary. Because she's a witch who works here. Everybody's witnessed. We're going to get one of these asshole dudes who's still left and her.
I'll tell you this. You're out there, so you know. Those guys left. When you guys left the room, they left.
No, the drunk gnome at the end of the...
Oh, the dwarf.
Yeah, we're going to get the dwarf. We're going to get her. We're going to go down to the notary. We're going to have this place signed over to us. And we'll be having
what time is it?
Income coming
it's
in.
It's like 3:30-ish.
Income. Think about the income. Every single day, gold.
But we got to get paid for this.
Yeah,
this
we'll just
mission.
Stop. We'll stop at the notary on the way to the mission.
Where's the notary at?
You would be able to find one in front of the Great Gray Hall of the Council of Mages.
Great. Mm-hmm. We'll just stop by. We're going to bring the dwarf, bring her. She owes us, right? And we'll just have our own strip club.
All right. Let's do this.
Day.
Let's move. We got to move.
All right.
I leave with a big plate of buffet food.
Oh, and what's her name is, are you okay?
Naya. So she was like, just shaking still behind there.
You okay?
And she's like, she does seem okay, but she almost seems like she starts talking to you like she's coming out of a little bit of a fog. Mm-hmm. She goes like, oh my God. I haven't talked to my mom in so long.
Yeah, you remember working here though, right?
Yeah, okay. But I remember just...
Because you're the last person who works here right now.
So yeah.
You just...
It's crazy. I just remember thinking I loved these witches like sisters.
Yeah, that's crazy. Would you consider say that you...
Why did I think that?
You basically became a witch though, right? I mean, we can all agree on that.
Yeah, I just wanted to dance, but I joined the coven.
That's
and...
all I need you to say
right,
in front
witch.
Of the
Let's
notary.
Go. Let's get go. Out of here.
What's happening?
We're going to go do some business, all right?
Killed them all.
You're with us.
We saved you.
I'm just having a lot of complex emotions because I don't feel attached to them anymore.
But
I know, like, as soon as an hour ago, I felt like I was in love.
I use command on her.
I will say, you haven't like gotten that back from that last fight yet. Oh. That one was. So you, don't have, you can't yet. You'll all get right. to it. Like it'll take a little bit longer.
We're gonna bring you back home. We're gonna bring you back home, but we need to stop by the notary and have you witness this. We're signing this place over so that it never falls into dangerous hands ever again.
Okay.
Great. Can you grab that dwarf? I'm probably strongest. Can I grab the dwarf?
Yeah.
You roll grab. Strength check.
Right. 13
plus
3,
16? Sure.
Great.
And I'll tell you this. Naya seems pretty willing to sign it over and say, so you can totally bring the dwarf as backup. They, side note, I just saw that the people voted that you should, 60% of the audience thinks you should burn the mom's house down. Oh my God.
If I was convinced by her, I'll leave the dwarf. Great.
So you want to go to the Council of Mages?
Yeah, to the notary.
Okay.
Let's go.
So you go there, and as you walk, she seems like, the further along away from it you get, she seems more like she's more like, yeah, that was crazy. I mean, like, I don't feel like I was there not of my own accord.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I wasn't being kept, but yeah. I don't know why I wanted to stay so much.
Oh, do I have command yet?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna save it though. We keep walking. Shut it, lady. We saved you. We get it. You were under a spell.
So she's annoying Jimmy this entire walk, and you get to the Great Great Hall.
All right. We just want to go straight to the notary?
Yeah, there's a. You can find it pretty quickly on the directory.
Go with the deed and the witch to the notary, and I'm like, hi. There was a bit of a mix-up, and we were supposed to. I don't know where my lawyer is. This deed to this club on the outside of town. We're trying to get it transferred over to us.
Uh-huh.
We are the three new owners, but there was a problem with the paperwork. Anyway, we've got the deed. I don't remember who we talked to last time, but they said all we had to do is come back with the deed with the witness from the business and sign it over.
Okay, thank you. Could I just see that, please?
There you go.
And this, there's a little, like, desk gnome behind it. He, like, looks at it with his eyeglasses pushed down. Okay, let me just cross-reference this deed number. Okay. And he kind of, like, goes and looks in a file cabinet. Mm-hmm. It's bureaucracy. It's taking a little bit. So it's, like, 4 when you guys get to the hall.
Mm-hmm.
But he does it. Like, you don't have to convince him or anything. Like, the deed is the deed.
Great.
And Naya has identification that she works with the company. So, like, yeah, they let you sign it over. You don't have to roll or anything.
Yay!
And it takes, like, a half hour or so. So it's 4:30. Now, I'll tell you this. You know that Tavlin's closes at 5. So you have to get back to Tavlin's if you want to complete and get the money from the contract.
Mm-hmm.
You could also just, you could still probably make your way to the Rialto's house and return Naya there. And get back in time. I'm going to tell you this. You probably don't have time to burn the house down and get back to Tavlin's.
Wait a minute. We now own...
You do own a strip club.
We own a strip club. Can we burn Tavlin's down?
I mean, you can try. I'm not going to stop you.
Great.
It might make my life in upcoming episodes more difficult.
Let's do it.
But...
Let's do it. I warned that guy. I warned that guy. I'm still a were-raccoon.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I agree. So, I completely agree.
So we head back to Tavlin's.
With Naya.
With Naya.
Yeah.
Okay. So you go back to Tavlin's.
On the way there, I want to try and convince Naya.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be like, hey, just so you know, there's a guy on the inside here who helped sell you over to the witches, and we're going to get revenge.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to take this guy out. We're going to burn down his building. And we're going to make sure that nobody is ever put in a position that you were put in ever again. Also, I want you to know, you can keep your job. If you want, you can dance in any way that you're comfortable.
You. I do want to dance.
Oh, great. So you're...
My interest in dance, that's a separate fight with my mom.
You
that has nothing
lead,
to
you
do.
You are a headliner.
Because I feel like there's such a rich history about burlesque, and I just think it's a good way to feel powerful.
Right, we got
to
get back to the place. We need to get this money. We need to get this money.
She's starting to go on a tangent.
So
she is a little reluctant once you guys get there. So what's your plan for burning this place down?
Do we get the money? Do we have money?
What are you doing?
Hey,
You're out in front of Tavlin's Temporium right now.
Let's go in. Let's get paid.
Yeah.
Okay. Show that we saved Naya.
Don't I have some kind of firepower?
Step one. We'll figure it out.
So you walk in and Tavlin's
legacy.
Tavlin walks in, or you guys walk in and Tavlin's there, and kind of like tidying up as he's getting ready to close up shop, and he says, "Hello, adventurers! Welcome back!
Hi! Look what we've got."
Who's this?
This is Naya. We finished that contract.
Oh, this is the girl.
Yeah.
Well, let me just check. Has she been home yet? Does her mother know that she's
been? Don't you do this, man.
Well, I'm sorry. It's just the
fucking do this.
I start walking around the room, dropping my 10 torches in different areas of the room.
Are you lighting them? Or
no, they're lit.
Okay.
I'm assuming they're torches. If it's not lit, it's not a torch.
Well, I mean, a torch is like, it's got like a oil-soaked rag at the top.
Yeah. All right, I'm lighting them.
You're lighting them? What are you doing?
You give us our fucking money.
You're a monster.
I can't. It's locked inside the pocket dimension of the contract until it's...
As you're doing that, Tavlin is wearing wizard robes. He casts...
Oh, no.
Okay. He casts... As soon as the first one goes down, he flings his hand over and casts Create Water, and water falls on top of it.
What time is it right now?
It is like 4:45.
Okay.
And there's no way because it's a half hour away to get to that Bleecker Street place, so we're not going to get paid.
Well, look, why are you trying to set this place on fire?
What magical god doesn't understand that she's no longer kidnapped?
Well, it's not a god, per se. Magic doesn't work on it's divine magic.
Yeah, well, what conscious entity which locks this thing knows that it should not be unlocked right now?
Well, it's not conscious. It's a spell. It's where the spell is constructed. But look, I can stay open a little longer if you want to send her back.
Send her back? Like, trust her to go home on her own?
Well, young lady, will you go home? And Naya kind of says, like, yes, that's where I wanted to go. You guys dragged me here when you said you were going to burn down this place.
That's a party metaphor.
We're like going to raise the roof. Yeah. And burn
it down. A party! Wonderful!
Yeah, yeah.
To celebrate party. The completing
we
of this
should
mission.
Have company parties.
How about this? I will go with Naya to drop her off at her mom's place, and you guys stay here and make sure we get paid. We'll all meet up at the bar.
All right. If it's 4:45-ish, I'm going to run over to the jewelry shop because they close at 5:30.
You don't have any money? Oh, yeah, yeah. I do.
So I'm going to pick up the thing off the layaway.
All right. So we got a lot to do before we wrap this up. So you're taking Naya back?
I'm taking Naya back.
You're taking Naya back. You run there. What are you doing, Miles? Are you staying here to
collect? I'm staying here, and I'm trying to figure out a way to burn this place down.
Okay.
Still.
You're right in the jewelry shop. Mm-hmm. So you all get to the places you're going just in the nick of time. So you get there, you drop Naya off. Are you doing anything else there?
Yeah, I want to say a couple words to this woman.
Oh, my God, Naya here. Oh, hi, Mom. I'm so sorry. I don't know what happened. Those witches... I was like I wanted to be there. I had a drink, and then my head got fuzzy, and then... It was like I couldn't leave after they hired me. I'm just so happy you're back. So they're having a heart-to-heart.
I want you to know, lady.
Thank you so much.
This is a feeling I will never have.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I'll never get this reunion.
I'm so sorry for your loss, but thank you. I hope you can take some solace in the fact that you've reunited me with my daughter.
Yeah, you know what I'd rather take? My own life, if it can give... My daughter, her life, where?
I can't, but I'm so sorry. You can spend any holiday with us if you want.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yep, I'll be here.
She opens her arms, offering a hug.
I don't take it.
You don't take it? Okay. So then you make it to the jewelry shop, and the high elf who's behind the counter is very like, man, I'm cutting it rather close, aren't we, sir? However, we still have it here. Mm-hmm. And do you have the 15 agreed upon gold?
First off, Did you hear how we saved the girl and how awesome it was?
Yes, I heard when he told me about that when you were here previously. That's okay. What we got okay. to 15
All right.
gold.
Also then, well, how about this? How much can I get for this? Some jewelry that...
Naya's jewelry?
Mm-hmm. You didn't get a hack.
I forgot, but you are 100% right. So he, like, may I inspect it?
Please.
This is very nice. Looks like it was passed down for a few generations, maybe. This is old work. This is lovely. Yes, I would trade this for this pendant.
Wait. So you would trade it? Yes. You just said a lot of stuff that makes it seem like, give me that back. That seems expensive. It's expensive. You're trying to, sitting here trying to.
I'll give you this pendant and 12 gold.
Oh, you give me that pendant and 12 gold?
Now, I gave you a pretty deal on this pendant. I'm talking about the original value of this pendant. It seems like a good deal to me, my friend.
Mm-hmm. How about this? How about I don't give you this. You give me that pendant for free, and I will give you a lifetime pass to the new strip club that I have. Anytime you want, no charge. Just tell them you know Guaplar 3000, they let you right in.
I'm a married man, and I am not interested in that.
Okay, I mean, you don't know. You haven't seen some of the girls we got there. And I mean, and it's nice and clean. It's like not anything. It's not too dirty. It's just like just right.
What's the name of this club?
Well, it's under construction right now. We're figuring out what.
Sir, I can't take passes to a construction strip.
Well, it's not under construction. It just means like the. Well, it's like the witch, the old witch hut. Like witch.
Roll a persuasion check.
17.
So with your bonus, that's 23. So he's like saying, like, I am married, and he kind of like looks around like to see if anyone is coming in. He kind of leans forward and says, unlimited lifetime.
Unlimited lifetime, man. Like, say Guaplar 3000, like they don't know you at the door by the time after the first
like, room. Like a membership card or something that I can, because I would like it to be discreet.
Oh, the most discreet part of the club. You always have access to the VIP section in the back. Now, don't get me wrong, like, okay. You still have to tip the dancers, but...
Oh, of course.
Okay, he just cashed in 7 times. Like, the value of that necklace was only 7 trips to the strip club.
He gives you the pendant and accepts the agreed-upon lifetime membership.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
So,
meanwhile, great. Back at the place,
yes.
I'm trying to cast command... to sleep.
On Javelin?
Yes.
Oh my god.
He saves against it.
Oh. Damn it.
Please stop that. I can tell when you're trying to cast a spell on me. Well, it looks like the contract is unlocked. And let's see, we have here for each of you.
I'll take it off.
Oh, wonderful. You'll
I'll make sure they get it.
Let's see. We have. 10 gold each.
That's so, it?
Yeah.
This job sucks, Tavlin.
I got one.
Fine, give me the 30 gold.
So 30 gold, and there's actually in here, there's one other thing, and it looks like this was addressed, has a little note, that this specifically goes, as voted upon by the audience, to Cratch. The piece, one piece of loot is, it looks to be a filter of love. And he pulls out like a potion-looking vial, and he hands you, this.
All right. All right.
Make sure that gets to Cratch.
I'll make sure Cratch gets this. So I got 30 gold, right?
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
You gave me 30 gold too, right?
Yeah. Which he's giving to you with the assumption you're gonna get.
Yeah, I know.
Can I go back inside this house real quick?
Naya's house?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. I want to ask. Hey guys, I'm so sorry to interrupt. You know, as a mom, I just want to make sure that I would like you to convince me that you're never gonna let your daughter out of her sight ever again.
Naya is immediately like. Froze her brow. I was like, well, that seems ridiculous.
Yeah, but you haven't lost a daughter, and maybe someday you will. I just want to know from your mom if you guys are gonna if you're gonna keep your eyes on her.
Oh my god, of course I am. I could never bear for this to happen again.
Am I convinced of this?
You tell me. Do you want to do an insight check to see if you can believe her?
Yeah, I want to see if I believe her.
Roll a d20. And add your wisdom.
11.
11? You're reasonably sure. I mean, you think. Cratch thinks. I think I can trust her.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
If at any point I stop by randomly and she's not either at the club or at your house, I will kill you and she'll be my daughter then. you understand me?
Okay, I mean, we invited you to our home for the holidays.
I know, but I was thinking about it, and I just want to make sure that you know that if you take your daughter's existence for granted, I will behead you.
God.
And she'll be my daughter.
Okay.
Great.
It kind of like put a dampen on the excitement they were of seeing each other again. Because the mother is kind of scared, and the daughter is both scared and like, this is ridiculous. I'm not going to stay in this house my entire life.
Can I get into the Tavlins and realize no one is there?
What do you do?
I'm assuming like I've left Tavlins because I figure you can close up now, Tavlin, because I got this potion for Cratch, and I've got all their gold.
Uh-huh.
I'll get it to them. So I'm assuming Tavlin would close up.
Yeah, he says goodbye and thank you. Have a wonderful evening.
And so I'm waiting outside Tavlin's when I'm assuming these two get back.
So you're going back to Tavlin's. Yeah. Are you going?
I'm going to the bar that I said we were all going to meet at.
All right. Well, then I would hang out in front of Tavlin's for all. I bet Cratch went to the bar. Let's go there. Right.
All
right.
So you guys go to the bar.
I go to the bar and I come in and I tell them that Tavlin stiffed us and told us, you know, we can go fuck ourselves if we want to get paid. What are we going to do about it?
I think that we should have a side business in the strip club, which is issuing contracts for temp jobs. Like, if people need a place to go, they can come, have a drink, we'll set up in the office, they can come in and get a contract from us. And the next time I see you guys, let's just kill Tavlin and take his contracts.
It makes sense. Right. Oh, also, let me run by you guys. I forgot. The jewelry store guy, free admission for the entire, for the rest of his life.
What did he give you?
That necklace for free.
He gave you one necklace. It was 15 gold.
Free admission for life.
Yeah. I mean, but it's only. I mean, it's not. I mean it's
cover.
He still has to pay. It's just cover. He still has to pay the dancers.
Yeah, but he gave that up in one. What the hell's wrong with you?
And with that, for the night. And you guys completed your quest. Mostly, yeah, you did it. Yeah. You did it.
And I, of course, am not giving this to
you. Yeah, so mark down on your equipment list that you have another 30 gold and a filter of love. And that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to watch this or other older episodes of this show, we're actually putting them all up on a YouTube archive. It's youtube.com/play. You can watch older episodes there. This one will probably be up in a week or two. Then if you want to submit a suggestion for a job for these guys to go on, not these ones specifically, but our guests, Will, and underneath the info in our Twitch page, has a link to a Google form where you can suggest an adventure for Tavlin's Temporium to give out. We do that on the last week of each month. We do a user-submitted adventure. Did you already put up the vote for next week's adventure?
Right, it's up right now.
Okay, great. If you want to vote on what next week's adventure is, it's currently up on jash.com/play. You can vote between your two options, which are submitted by viewers. Option one, Shadow Upon Doc Ward by Roll for Drunkage. Or option two, The Brothers of Barrymore, submitted by Noah Hammer. So check that out. And that adventure we're doing next week in a special nighttime show. We're going to start trying to do this about once a month. We do a nighttime show for here in LA instead of an afternoon show. That is going to be at 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time next Thursday, the 26th, with Reggie Watts,
Woo!
Zach Perlman,
Woo!
And Becca Scott Kearns from Geek & Sundry. Mm. So that'll be pretty fun. Please come back and watch that. And I think that's it. Sorry, PST. Oh, also, Jash has another streaming show. I think it's on the info page what time it's at, right?
You mean tomorrow?
11 a.m. We've got another show starting called Future Garbage that is a crafting show with comedians. But the first one, it's done one or two before, but the next of that is tomorrow at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Okay, I think that's all the plugs. Guys, do you guys have anything you want to plug?
My name is Ronnie Adrian. Just look for me. I'm not on Twitter, so you can follow me if you want, but it won't matter because I'm never on it.
Good plug.
Support Indie Improv. And yeah.
Cool. Miles?
All things Pack Theater, packtheater.com. Come nice. Check us out.
And is that a P-A-C-K?
If, yeah, P-A-C-K.
Yeah, just making sure in case. I assume you put it in the chat, but just making sure in case.
Follow me at Heather Campbell on Twitter, at Heather Ann Campbell on Instagram. I don't know what my Snapchat name is, but it's my icon on everything. And please watch Whose Line Is It Anyway on CW.
When does the show start again?
It started.
Oh, it's already started.
Yeah, I don't know what I don't know when I'm on, but eventually I will be again.
Sorry. I thought you said in the beginning that the new season was
The new
starting.
Season is has just started again.
Cool.
Yeah.
Great. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. We're going to take a very short break, and then we'll do a quick Q&A, just a little bit more casual thing. We'll be in the chat. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, guys.